सभी को मेरा नमस्कार। प्रत्येक शुक्रवार को एक नया लेक्चर जैसे ही हम आपके सामने उपस्थित होते हैं, इसी तरीके से आज भी हम प्रत्येक दिन की तरह नया लेक्चर, नया ज्ञान, नया समुद्र, नया उत्साह। और फिर से हमारा जो एक उद्देश्य है कि हम अनेक श्रेष्ठ वैद्यों का निर्माण कर सके, और उसके लिए हम अपने सभी स्पीकर्स का, व्याख्यानकर्ता का तहे दिल से आभारी है। उन सभी का आभार मानते हुए मैं आज का लेक्चर की शुरुआत करने से पूर्व आज के लेक्चर के स्पीकर को मैं आप सबके सामने इंट्रोड्यूस करना चाहूंगी। आज का लेक्चर डॉक्टर पूनम गौरव सावरकर जी आज के लेक्चर्स को डिलीवर करेंगे। आप वर्तमान समय में अभी एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर और पीएचडी सुपरवाइजर इन द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ पंचकर्मा महात्मा गांधी आयुर्वेदिक कॉलेज एंड हॉस्पिटल एंड रिसर्च सेंटर में अभी सालोद दत्ता मेघे यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ द हायर एजुकेशन एंड रिसर्च इंडिया वर्धा महाराष्ट्र में अभी वर्तमान समय में आप कार्य कर रहे हैं। आपका टोटल टीचिंग एक्सपीरियंस 12 इयर्स का है और आपका रिसर्च एक्सपीरियंस 15 साल का है। टोटल आपने 33 अवार्ड्स को जीता है। मुझे बहुत ही अच्छा लग रहा था। मैं सभी पार्टिसिपेंट्स को कहना चाहूंगी कि आज भी दैदीप्यमान व्यक्तित्व वाले लोगों की कमी नहीं है। रामदास अवहार्ड सर और उसके बाद आप है कि जो बहुत सारे अवार्ड के धनी है, जिसमें बेस्ट टीचर नेशनल अवार्ड ऑफ द पंचकर्मा यूजी इन 2022 बाय द आयुर्वेदा टीचर्स एसोसिएशन आपको दिया गया है। बेस्ट इनोवेटिव पीएचडी थीसिस के लिए 2021 में अवार्ड फॉर एक्सेलेंस इन द पंचकर्मा 2021 में, बेस्ट हाउसमैन अवार्ड इन 2010 में इन पोस्ट के जो टीचिंग इन द आर ए पोद्दार आयुर्वेदिक मेडिकल कॉलेज वर्ली मुंबई से प्राप्त हुआ है। बेस्ट स्टूडेंट अवार्ड, यानी मुझे लगता है कि हर एक जगह, चाहे रिसर्च अवार्ड है चाहे बेस्ट टीचर अवार्ड है, हमेशा आपने उसको प्राप्त किया है। 18 बेस्ट पेपर अवार्ड भी आपको मिले हुए हैं और एक रिसर्च इंसेंटिव अवार्ड भी आपको मिला है, जहां भी पोस्टर प्रेजेंटेशन में 4 बार बेस्ट अवार्ड, ऐसे में 5 बार बेस्ट अवार्ड, इसी तरीके से बहुत सारे अवार्ड्स हैं जिसको मैं बहुत ब्रीफ में आप सभी के सामने रख रही हूँ। आपने एक पेटेंट भी लिया हुआ है, ग्रांटेड 1 फॉर एपरेटस फॉर प्रिपरेशन ऑफ द हर्बल एनिमा एंड 1 पेटेंट फॉर द पोर्टेबल जानू बस्ती इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स के लिए भी आपने प्राप्त किया हुआ है। आयुर्वेदिक सॉफ्टवेयर डिजाइनिंग में भी आपने डेवलपमेंट ऑफ द प्रकृति परीक्षण सॉफ्टवेयर 2023 आपने बनाया हुआ है। पब्लिकेशन आपका 4 बुक्स का है, 55 चैप्टर्स इन द डिफरेंट 14 बुक्स इन द नेशनल एंड इंटरनेशनल पब्लिशिंग हाउस में आपने दिया हुआ है। 114 से ज्यादा आपके वेरियस इंटरनेशनल जर्नल्स और डिफरेंट नेशनल जर्नल्स में आपके आर्टिकल्स, रिसर्च आर्टिकल पब्लिश्ड है और रिसर्च पेपर के प्रेजेंटेशन मोर देन 92 आपने किया हुआ है। और इसी के साथ साथ वर्क इन द रिसर्च पब्लिकेशन भी आपका डिफरेंट डिफरेंट जगह पर है, वर्किंग एज एसोसिएट एडिटर, सेक्शन एडिटर, एडिटोरियल मेंबर, रिव्यूअर ऑफ द वेरियस जर्नल्स भी आप अपनी भूमिका निभा रहे हैं। 53 से ज्यादा आपने एज अ रिसोर्स पर्सन या एज अ गेस्ट स्पीकर आपने अपना व्याख्यान दिया हुआ है। एज अ चेयर एंड को चेयर भी आपने नेशनल इंटरनेशनल कॉन्फ्रेंस में 22 टाइम्स आपने अपना उत्तरदायित्व निभाया है, आपकी भूमिका रही है। तो मैं समझती हूँ कि 22 इसमें 2 आयुष, 1 इंटरनेशनल और 19 यूनिवर्सिटी लेवल पे आपने रिसर्च प्रोजेक्ट भी कंप्लीट किए हैं और अभी वर्तमान समय में 3 प्रोजेक्ट आपके ऑन गोइंग है। मुझे लगता है कि बहुत एक्स्ट्रा ऑर्डिनरी आपका सीवी है और मैं समझती हूँ कि इसके माध्यम से बहुत सारे आयुर्वेद के चिकित्सक प्रेरणा लेंगे और कहीं ना कहीं आयुर्वेद में अपनी अपनी भूमिका को और अच्छे तरीके से निभाने के लिए ये सभी लोग उद्यत रहेंगे और कार्यकारी उसमें आएंगे। और आज का लेक्चर 445वां लेक्चर, और आज के लेक्चर का अपना टॉपिक है वेरियस सक्सेसफुल केस स्टडीज विद द हेल्प ऑफ द कोलोबरेटिव यूज ऑफ शोधन एंड समन चिकित्सा इन द आयुर्वेदा। एक्सेलेंट टॉपिक है, मैं समझती हूँ कि आज हम इन व्याख्यान के ज्ञान के माध्यम से अपने बहुत सारे पेशेंट्स की स्वास्थ्य प्राप्ति की कामना को पूरा कर पाएंगे। बहुत बहुत स्वागत है डॉक्टर पूनम सावरकर जी, ओवर टू यू। हेलो डॉक्टर पूनम जी, हेलो हाँ जी डॉक्टर साहब जी, हाँ जी 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 मैंने ऑन कर दिया, ऑन कर दिया जी जी ओके ओके जी जी
ओके थैंक यू वेरी मच मैम फॉर नाइस इंट्रोडक्शन।
वेलकम। और
या
वो एक्चुअली क्या पता है कुछ क्लिक हो गया था तो वो
या हो सकता है, नो इश्यू मैम, नो इश्यू।
वेलकम।
ओके आई विल शेयर द पीपीटी एंड विल अगेन चेक वेदर स्लाइड इज रनिंग प्रॉपरली और नॉट। ओके पीपीटी इज विजिबल मैम? Yeah, but I am changing the slide. Slides are changing.
Slide change नहीं हो रही है। आप है ना ऐसे करिए, ये जो side वाली slide है ना थोड़ी छोटी करके
yes. I will do it. I think ma'am Google Meet में थोड़ा issue आता है, I think so. हाँ बाकी Zoom पे सही चलता है, कोई दिक्कत नहीं आती है। बाकी अदर जो अपने इमिनेंट स्पीकर रहे हैं इसके पहले के, उनको भी ये दिक्कत आई है क्या?
नहीं वैसे हो जाता है, मगर मैं सामान्य रूप से कह सकती हूं कि फर्स्ट स्लाइड करने के बाद जो साइड में जो तीन चार स्लाइड दिखती है ना उस बार थोड़ा मिनिमाइज कर ले तो वी कैन गेट द मैक्सिमम।
ओके
है ना, तो
या आई विल ट्राई। ओके नाउ पीपीटी इज विजिबल?
अभी नहीं हुई जैसा दिख नहीं रही।
ओके नाउ इट इज ओके मैम?
यस नाउ ओके ओके
ओके ओके हियर आई एम चेंजिंग द स्लाइड।
हाँ हाँ अब ठीक है, चेंज हो रही है जी।
ओके चलो वेरी गुड। चलो वेरी वार्म, एक्चुअली वार्म ही बोलना चाहिए। गुड इवनिंग टू ऑल सीनियर फैकल्टीज, ऑल कलीग्स, ऑल डियर स्टूडेंट यूजी पीजी हु आर प्रेजेंट ऑन दिस वर्चुअल प्लेटफॉर्म। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई एम वेरी थैंकफुल डॉक्टर हेतल मैम, डॉक्टर रश्मि फॉर गिविंग मी सच अ नाइस अपॉर्चुनिटी टू शेयर माय सम एक्सपीरियंसेस। एक्चुअली आई एम नॉट टीचिंग टू नॉट एनी वन, एक्चुअली जस्ट आई एम शेयरिंग विच आई हैव डन इन माई क्लिनिकल प्रैक्टिस। ओके सो इन टूडेज लेक्चर वी विल फोकस और वी विल डिस्कस द सच अ फाइव क्लिनिकल कंडीशंस विच आर क्वाइट चैलेंजिंग फॉर द ट्रीटमेंट इन द करंट सिनारियो। दैट इज द फर्स्ट ऑफ केस इज दैट इज ऑस्टियोमायलाइटिस ऑफ द टिबिया, सेकंड वन स्पाइनल कॉर्ड इंड्यूस पैराप्लेजिया, पैंक्रियाटिक कार्सिनोमा, फोर्थ केस इज क्रोनिक पैंक्रियाटाइटिस, and fifth one that is the pemphigus folliculitis. Actually I have did actually total 105 presentation, among them total 76 there are the case studies are there, but I have selected such a challenging cases which are quite difficult for the treatment or there are certain hurdles while treating, and all these cases are totally managed with the intervention of collaborative, that is the collaborative use of shodhan, that is panchakarma chikitsa and shaman chikitsa, though that's why I am putting here. So we will move forward. दिस इज द फर्स्ट केस दैट इज द रोल ऑफ आयुर्वेदा इन मैनेजमेंट ऑफ क्रोनिक इन्फेक्टिव ऑस्टियोमायलाइटिस. इट वॉज द केस स्टडी ऑफ द 41 ईयर्स ओल्ड मेल फीमेल पेशेंट. शी वॉज अप्रोच्ड मी बिफोर द कोविड. She was residing at the Vardha and belongs to the upper middle family. When she was approached to me, there was the basic chief complaint was there. You can see here the, in the picture at that time I have taken. That is, there was the swelling over left ankle joint. Throbbing pain was there. You can see the blackish discoloration also, which is prominently showing in the picture. There was tenderness over the left ankle joint on the medial aspect especially. And due to all this pain, swelling and tenderness, there was a significant decreased range of motion of left ankle joint. And that's why she was completely unable to climb the upstairs also. Okay. And along with that tingling sensation, she was suffering with all these symptoms since 9 months. There were certain associated complaints was also there, that is intermittent constipation, especially the unsatisfactory bowel movement was there, though the frequency was regular, but unsatisfactory feeling was there. Second one, lack of appetite was there. Jiva was also soft and general weakness, that is general malaiseness. In the history, due to this clinical condition, there was no significant family history was found. In past history, she was suffering with the allergic rhinitis since childhood. So we can consider some autoimmune responses as well as some cough predominance also. She was known case of elephantiasis of the right leg since 6 years. And apart from that, due to the osteomyelitis, generally in osteomyelitis, what happens? There was the necrosis or the death of certain bone tissues occurs. So, generally in the tuberculous infection, such kind of osteomyelitis was often, or sometimes trauma is the major factor in the causation of these diseases. But in this case, there were absent of both these causative factor. In the personal history, the patient used to take mixed type of diet, and particularly she had craving of madhur and amla rasa, specifically the excess intake of tea along with some pickles also. So excessive intake of that. So that's why I have put here madhur and amla ras. Sleep was sound. There was no bowel habit. As I said earlier, unsatisfactory was there. Micturition was okay. And actually this patient was completely symptom free before 9 months. But what happened? Suddenly she developed with the chief complaint, which I already mentioned, that is throbbing pain, especially that the pain was aggravated at the night. Fever with chills was also there. Sometimes the fevers up to the 102 to 103 was there. Agitation was there due to that throbbing pain. Post discharge from the inner aspect of left ankle joint and swelling was there. And that's why she was investigated for the all essential pathological and radiological investigations suggested by her family physician. And she was, and after that, her family physician referred to the general surgeon. And she diagnosed as acute pyogenic osteomyelitis, which was the primary diagnosis of this patient. So, and for that purpose, she underwent conservative treatment, generally the aspiration with the and multiple surgical debridement. These are the existing treatment modalities for the acute pyogenic osteomyelitis in the contemporary science. And she underwent for all this treatment for consecutive 2 months. But what happened? First discharge, fever, severe throbbing pain were subsided for the 15 days. But after 15 days, after undergoing all this aspiration and all this therapy, after treatment, 15 days, again throbbing pain and swelling was observed. And there was marked decreased range of motion, reappeared again. So that's why there was the deterioration in the radiological findings also, which I will show later. That is the radiological finding of that patient at the time of diagnosis also, and during the treatment also, and after completion of the Ayurvedic treatment. And so that why there was no complete relief due to the conservative management and surgical debridement in the modern science. And that's why patient approached to our Mahatma Gandhi Ayurvedic Hospital for the Ayurvedic management before COVID. These are the, I have put here, the all treatment protocol which she had taken previously, whether it is allopathic or surgical one, आई हैव पुट हियर इन अ क्रोनोलॉजिकल मैनर. यू कैन से हियर द एमआरआई लेफ्ट लेग विच वॉज सजेस्टेड बाय हर सर्जन शोज दैट एक्यूट ऑस्टियोनेक्रोसिस इन द हेड ऑफ राइट फीमर, स्लेरोसिस, आर्टिकुलर मार्जिनल इरेग्युलरिटी, हाइपोप्लेजिया विथ ग्रॉस ऑस्टियोपोरोटिक चेंजेस वॉज ऑकर्ड. At that time, the ESR was 66%, which shows the infective pathology. Sickle cell was doubtful because generally in a tuberculosis infection and sickle cell, both these conditions are more vulnerable for getting such kind of osteomyelitis condition. CRP, again inflammatory marker, it was 75, and that's why patient was admitted in a private hospital under the orthopedic surgeon. And certain antibiotic, especially augmentin, analgesic, aspiration, which tissue draining from bone marrow, as I said earlier, was done by that general surgeon. In May 2017, the TB PCR, because the tuberculosis is the chief causative factor in certain condition, but it was not detected in the patient. A report on microbiology, that is biopsy, was done. No growth even after 15 days because all antibiotic course was over for the patient. Histological study of the aspirated tissue shows pyogenic osteomyelitis of shin tibia, which was in left leg, with Brody's abscess. Generally, the Brody's abscess generally found in the tuberculosis infection. And so that's why surgeon has decided for the curettage tissue from the left tibia, that is half distal part. And along with that, some analgesic, calcium supplement, vitamin C for the wound healing was advised for the patient. X-ray left ankle joint again show periosteal endosclerosis, medial aspect, medial condyle. You can see here in this image also. All these symptoms, here I am showing with arrow. You can see the particular sequestrum, which is get detached from the main bone. And it is the unique feature of the osteomyelitis. And you can, an X-ray showing the same thing, that is the sequestrum with peripheral sclerosis and sclerotic changes in the medullary cavity of the bone, that is the left tibia. And in July 2017, due to all this treatment medication, antibiotic and all these intervention, there was again some GIT disturbances was occurred. There was severe loss of appetite was there. And at that time, when LFT done, there was some impaired LFT was observed. And that's why at that time, she approached for the Ayurvedic treatment to us. So in Ashtavida Parikshana, you can see here, Nadi was Samyak, Mala, as I said earlier, intermittent constipation, Mutra was Samyak, Jiva was Sam. So we correct first the Samavastha of this condition. Rest of the clinical condition was Ashtavida Parikshan heads was okay. Prakruti of the patient, that is Vata Pitta, other findings were same. But in Vikruti, I have found that is the Kapha Pradhan Tridosha Dushti along with Rakta, Kandara, Asthi, Majja, Dusha was there. Jatharagni and Vayam Shakti was Alpa. In local examination of this patient, I found fibrotic scarring marks with blackish discoloration, dark, poor nourished skin over left ankle joint and medial and distal aspect over swelling. No varicosity was there. No signs of fresh wound was there. But there was the altered joint mechanics, that is joint stiffness was there. And sign of elephantiasis of the right lower limb. These are the inspection findings. On palpation, slightly raised local temperature with mild tenderness over joint line and around the scar at the site of debridement. And there was obviously restricted joint movement, but no lymphadenopathy was occurred, which generally found in the tuberculosis infection. Nidan. Now we are focusing over the Nidan Panchak of this patient, that is Agantuj or Sankramanjanya, because no other any causative pathology was there, but ESR was raised, CRP was raised. Okay, so maybe in certain condition, polymicrobial infection, specifically the in osteomyelitis cases, Staphylococcus aureus, it is the basic or main pathogenic organism, and Streptococcus pneumonia. Both these species are the main causative organism for causing this osteomyelitis condition. Predisposing factor, Akruti was good, sudden weight loss was there, maybe due to the malnutrition, maybe due to the Jatharagni Mande, etc. Constipation, Vata Prakopa was there. Aharaj, Vishamashan, irregular food habits along with the excessive intake of Madhur and Amla Rasa. संप्राप्ति घटक हियर आई हैव टैबुलेटेड हियर दैट इज दोष कफ पित्त प्रधान त्रिदोषज दुष रक्त कंडरा अस्थि मज्जा दोषाधिष्ठान दैट इज अस्थि अग्नि बोध चाठर अग्नि मानदे एंड धातु अग्नि मानदे वॉज देयर स्रोतस इन्वॉल्व दैट इज विशिएटेड स्रोतस वेयर रस रक्त अस्थि मज्जाव एंड पुरुषव आई हैव टेकन मज्जाव बिकॉज देयर वॉज द दैट इज द डिस्टर्बेंसेस इन दी सॉरी बोन मैरो कनेक्टिविटी और नॉट अ कनेक्टिविटी इट इज द बोन मैरो टिश्यू डिस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ द बोन मैरो टिश्यू स्रोतोदुष्टि संग वॉज देयर विमार्ग गमन वॉज देयर उद्भव स्थान आमाशय पक्वाशय अधिष्ठान वॉज अस्थि एंड मज्जा विथ वात पित्त कफ दैट इज द त्रिदोष इन्वॉल्वमेंट वॉज देयर रोग मार्ग मध्यम व्याधि स्वभाव दैट इज चिरकाल जनरली द रिकरेंस इट इज द रिकरेंस इज द मेन फैक्टर इन दिस ऑस्टियोमायलिटिक कंडीशन संप्राप्ति ऑफ अस्थि मज्जागत विद्रधि हियर आई हैव टैब दैट इज अ क्रोनिक ऑस्टियोमायलिटिस acute inflammation of marrow tissues which generally leads to the spread of exudate along with the bone marrow spaces which leads to the thrombosis of vessel due to that compression and generally again after that necrosis of the bone tissue occur which again turns into the liquefaction of the necrotic tissue and lytic on periosteum causing further necrosis which is the exact pathology occurred in this patient so you can see the diagnosis according to the modern science The diagnosis was chronic focal sclerosing osteomyelitis of the distal end of the left tibia. You can see here the scar of the surgery also. And this is the radiological finding of that patient whose X-ray shows the particular sequestrum which is separated from the bone. And there is the destruction in the alignment also. Now, how we planned the specific treatment protocol for this patient. Considering the all dosha samarchana in this patient, the treatment protocol was decided in two stages, that is stage 1 and stage 2. In stage 1, totally emphasis was given specifically for amapachana, shothahara, srotodushti. And for srotodushti purpose or srotoshodhana purpose, we advise the kafahara, sukshma and tikshna. Along with that, some rakta prasadakara, that is rakta shodhak dravya was also advised. Parisechana was advised, which is a kind of dravasveda and Bhedan treatment was advised in the form of some shamana chikitsa. Blood purification and enhancing microcirculation, it is the main target of our treatment. Second one, specific in chronicity, because generally I said earlier Staphylococcus aureus and Staphylococcus pneumonia, these are the most causative organism. Generally in such cases, what happen? When patient take antibiotic, the all symptom get subsided. But when the duration of antibiotic or antibiotic coverage over, then again symptoms occur. Why this recurrence occur in such cases? Because both these organism make specific biofilm over that particular surrounding. And due to that particular biofilm, the antibiotic cannot penetrate through that biofilm to the affected lesion. So that's why the complete healing is not possible. So our aim was there that is we have to break that biofilm which is created by the organism and this biofilm breakage is only possible with the help of some rasakalpa because some rasakalpa that is herbo mineral formulations are prepared by making the putapaka that putapaka it is nothing but it enhances or it makes the medicine potent for the circulation or for the its deep penetration at the microcellular level. This is our the positive finding of our Ayurvedic formulations. So in stage 2, we have focused completely over the balya, bruhan and nourishing aspect. So treatment plan decided for this patient, sarvanga snehan with dhanvantar oil. Generally when swelling was there, generally with snehana contraindicated. But considering the pathology, chronicity of the disease and considering the vata prakopa in this patient, dhanvantar oil was prescribed for the just local application. Along with that, punarnavadi lepa, that is in that dashamula, punarnava, haridra, this certain anti-inflammatory analgesic Ayurvedic drugs were there, kalka was prepared and some paste was prepared and applied over that particular region. So this was continued for continuous 15 days. In Shaman Chikitsa, we have started, as I said earlier, some herbo mineral or rasakalpa combinations. दैट इज सुवर्ण समीर्पण ग्रस 20 टैबलेट्स वी हैव मेक सम स्पेसिफिक कॉम्बिनेशन बाय यूजिंग सुवर्ण समीर्पण ग्रस सूक्ष्म त्रिफला गुगुल गुडुची सत्व वी मेड 60 डोसेस आफ्टर दैट इट वॉज प्रिस्क्राइब विद इंदुकांत घृता विच इज इम्यूनो मॉड्युलेटर एंड अकॉर्डिंग टू आयुर्वेदा इट इज दीपन पाचन बिकॉज इट इज द श्रोत श्रोधर ऑल्सो सो इट वॉज एडवाइज्ड बीडी कैश्वर गुगुल वॉज एडवाइज एज अ रक्त प्रसादकर चिकित्सा ट्वाइस डेली वन अवर आफ्टर फूड अस्थि मज्जा पाचक चूर्ण तिथे गुडुची मुस्त अमलकी दिस इज द कॉम्बिनेशन इट वॉज एडवाइज इन इक्वल क्वांटिटी 5 ग्राम विथ लुकवॉर्म वॉटर स्पेसिफिकली इन दी एम्प्टी स्टमक फॉर द बेटर एब्सॉर्प्शन बिकॉज दिस कॉम्बिनेशन इज एडवाइज बाय दी इन अ विषम ज्वरा चिकित्सा दैट इज द अस्थि मज्जागत ज्वरा बाय दी चरक एंड वाग्भट ऑल्सो सो आय हॅव प्रिस्क्राइब्ड हियर आरोग्यवर्धिनी वटी बिफोर फूड फलत्रिकाधिक्वात बिफोर फूड अविपत्तिकर चूर्ण एज अ मृदु एंड नित्य विरेचना 10 ग्राम एट बेड टाइम विथ द लुकवॉर्म वॉटर साइमल्टेनियसली इन दिस स्टेज वन वॉज कम्प्लीटेड आफ्टर दैट इज आफ्टर 15 डेज वी हॅव स्टार्टेड और वी हॅव प्लॅन द सर्टन ट्रीटमेंट प्रोटो वी हॅव चेंज द ट्रीटमेंट प्रोटोकॉल इन स्टेज टू दॅट इज वी हॅव स्टार्टेड धारा ओव्हर द धन्वंतर ऑइल ओव्हर द लेफ्ट अँकल जॉईंट फॉर कॉन्झिक्युटिव्ह 15 डेज अलॉंग विथ दॅट देअर इज सम चेंज इन द ट्रीटमेंट प्रोटोकॉल फॉर द इंटरनल मेडिटेशन दॅट इज शमन चिकित्सा दॅट इज द हर्बो मिनरल कंपाऊंड कॉम्बिनेशन वॉज कंटिन्यूड बट आफ्टर दॅट वी हॅव ॲडेड लाक्षादी गुगुल फॉर द नरिशमेंट ऑफ दॅट बोन टिश्यू अस्थि मज्जा पाचक चूर्ण वॉज स्टील देअर द प्राइम एम ऑफ अस्थि मज्जा पाचक चूर्ण इज बेसिकली इट वॉज इंटेंड
हॅलो डॉक्टर पूनम हॅलो हॅलो डॉक्टर पूनम जी माधुरी जी हाँ वो आवाज नहीं है नो साउंड सही कह रहे हैं कुछ शायद इंटरनेट का हुआ दीपा मैम नमस्ते दीपा मैम हेलो
यस मैम
कुछ आप बात करेंगे कुछ चिकित्सा की या कुछ भी मैं ना उनको फोन करके आऊं डॉक्टर साहब कि एक बार पूछ लूं कि क्या हुआ
मैम मैं किसी के यहाँ हूँ अभी
अच्छा बाहर हो ओके
यस यस यस
अच्छा कोई बात नहीं चलो मैं
ओके ओके
अपना चिकित्सकीय अनुभव किमाया माधुरी और बहुत सारे लोग अपने रेगुलर लिसनर हैं कुछ हेल्प कर लेंगे क्योंकि ऑनलाइन की थोड़ी अपनी दिक्कतें रहती है तो बहुत बढ़िया लेक्चर चल रहा था अचला राम कुमावत जयपुर के स्टूडेंट डॉक्टर अचला राम थोड़ा सा मैसेज कर दो तो मैं है ना आपको को-होस्ट बना देती हूँ तो देन यू कैन डॉक्टर भुवनेश जी हेलो हेलो डॉक्टर भुवनेश जी मैंने आपको को-होस्ट बनाया डॉक्टर अनुराग सिंह चंदेल भी है डॉक्टर अनुराग किसी को तो आगे आना चाहिए भाई इतना ज्यादा ज्ञान का अवगाहन तो सारे लोग करते ही है मुझे लगता है कोई तैयार नहीं है मैं एक बार है ना डॉक्टर साहब को फोन करके आती हूँ क्योंकि उनको पता भी नहीं चला होगा वो लेफ्ट हो गए अच्छा डॉक्टर पूनम आप आ गए हेलो पार्टिसिपेंट में से वही रिक्वेस्ट कर रही थी कि कोई कुछ बोले तो मैं एक बार आपसे बात करके आऊं फोन करके ओके वेलकम अगेन जी 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 बहुत कानों में शहद गुड़
मैं
का, बहुत बढ़िया, बहुत अच्छी स्पीड से आपकी है ना प्रेजेंटेशन थी, मगर बहुत अच्छी थी जी डॉक्टर साहब। आपकी वॉइस अभी क्लियर नहीं है। हाँ डॉक्टर साहब जी, मेरी आवाज आ रही है डॉक्टर पूनम? आपकी अच्छी तरह से नहीं आ रही है। हेलो डॉक्टर पूनम, हेलो हेलो बलदेव सर, हेलो हेलो
हेलो। हाँ जी,
हाँ
हाँ
जी डॉक्टर।
जी,
हाँ थोड़ा सा कुछ संभालेंगे तो ठीक रहेगा, मैं डॉक्टर साहब से बात कर लूँ। वो कोई रिक्वेस्ट तो की थी मगर कोई आगे आया नहीं।
अच्छा ठीक है।
हाँ जी डॉक्टर शीतल भी है, डॉक्टर शीतल भागिया, काफी सारे लोग हैं मगर इंस्टेंट के लिए कोई।
मैम,
हाँ बेटा कुछ संभालो, कुछ बोलो तो मैं है ना मैडम को फोन करके आऊँ, वो फिर से आवाज नहीं आ रही है बेटा,
हाँ
ऐसा
ठीक
हो जाता
है।
है गांव में एक आध बार है ना।
यस
हेलो,
ओके
सॉरी, एक्सट्रीमली सॉरी फॉर द इंटरप्शन मैम।
मैडम।
आई डोंट नो व्हाट इज द इश्यू, ब्रेक बीच बीच में ऐसे हो रहा है। क्या होता है, लिंक लिंक चली जाती है अपनी।
अच्छा जी
जो हम फ्लो में रहते हैं ना, एक
हाँ जी
फ्लो में रहते हैं,
हाँ जी हाँ जी बिल्कुल
वो
ऐसा
थोड़ा
होता है।
डिस्टर्ब सा होता है।
हाँ जी
यस मैम, अभी पीपीटी इज विजिबल मैम।
हाँ जी, विजिबल विजिबल।
या ओके ओके, एक्सट्रीमली सॉरी फॉर द टेक्निकल एरर्स। सो दीज आर द रिजल्ट एंड ऑब्जर्वेशन विच आई ऑब्जर्व इन माई पेशेंट। यू कैन सी हियर आफ्टर द 6 मंथ, थ्रोबिंग पेन, टेंडरनेस ओवर द पर्टिकुलर लेफ्ट एंकल ज्वाइंट वॉज कम्प्लीटली अब्सेंट, रेंज ऑफ मोशन नो रिस्ट्रिक्शन, रिस्ट्रिक्टेड मूवमेंट, नो पेन वॉज देयर, जनरल मलाइजनेस वॉज माइल्ड, कॉन्स्टिपेशन वॉज नॉट ऑल्सो देयर,
भी हो रही
बट
है।
सिग्निफिकेंट फाइंडिंग वॉज ऑब्जर्व इन द दिस रेडियोलॉजिकल फाइंडिंग। यू कैन सी हियर इन द फर्स्ट, दैट इज द स्टार्ट इन एट द इनिशियल स्टेज ऑफ द एलोपैथिक ट्रीटमेंट, दिस वॉज द पिक्चर, दैट इज द पेरियोस्टियल एंडोस्टेरियल स्क्लेरोसिस, मेडियल एस्पेक्ट, मेडियल कॉन्डाइल रीजन एट द डिस्टल 2/3 लेफ्ट टिबिया, कैविटेशन और लिटिक लीजन वॉज ऑल्सो देयर। यू कैन सी पर्टिकुलरली हियर दैट इज देयर इज द डिसकंटिन्यूएशन इन द अलाइनमेंट ऑफ द बोन सेक्विस्ट्रम विद द पेरिफेरल स्क्लेरोसिस एंड मल्टीपल स्क्लेरोटिक चेंजेस वॉज फाउंड इन द मेडुलरी कैविटी ऑफ द टिबिया। आफ्टर 3 मंथ, दैट इज आफ्टर 3 मंथ्स ऑफ द आयुर्वेदिक मेडिकेशन, यू कैन सी हियर द देयर वॉज द स्टार्टिंग, दैट इज देयर वॉज द स्टार्टिंग फॉर द अलाइनमेंट ऑफ द सेक्विस्ट्रम, मॉडरेट स्क्लेरोसिस वॉज देयर, हीलिंग मॉडुलरी कैविटी एंड रिजॉल्विंग कैविटी एंड रिजॉल्विंग सेक्विस्टरियम ऑल्सो, बट आफ्टर 6 मंथ ऑफ द कंप्लीशन ऑफ द आयुर्वेदिक मेडिकेशन, यू कैन सी हियर देयर वॉज द कंप्लीट अलाइनमेंट, देयर वॉज द नो सेक्विस्ट्रम वॉज देयर, नो स्क्लेरोसिस वॉज देयर एंड नो मॉडुलरी कैविटी वॉज देयर, एंड यू कांट इमेजिन एक्चुअली टिल डेट देयर इज नो एनी रिकरेंस ऑफ द ऑस्टियोमायलाइटिस वॉज ऑब्जर्व इन दिस पेशेंट, एंड देयर इज टोटली पेशेंट इज टोटली सिम्टम फ्री। सो कमिंग टू अवर डिस्कशन, एज आई सेड अर्लियर, द मेन एम ऑफ दिस ट्रीटमेंट वॉज टू रेड्यूस द वैस्कुलर इनसेफिशियंसी विच वॉज अकर्ड ड्यू टू एडेक्वेट ड्रेनेज, एंड सो द मेन इंटेंशन ऑफ द ट्रीटमेंट वॉज टू मेक द रिवैस्कुलराइजेशन बाय रिड्यूसिंग द लोकल स्वेलिंग, लोकल इन्फ्लामेशन एंड बाय ऑब्लिटरिंग द डेड स्पेस, एंड सेकंड इंटेंशन वॉज ऑल्सो देयर फॉर द ओन प्रोटेक्शन, दैट इज द दुष्टव्रणा एंड विद्रधि चिकित्सा. एक्चुअली आई हैव अप्लाइड हियर द टोटल द ड्यूअल ट्रीटमेंट प्रिंसिपल ऑफ दुष्टव्रणा एज वेल एज अभ्यंतर विद्रधि चिकित्सा. सो शोतहरा एंड पाचन चिकित्सा वॉज एडवाइज टू अरेस्ट इट स्प्रेड एंड रिपेयर द डैमेज दैट इट वॉज कॉज्ड बाय ख वैगुण्य, मे बी ड्यू टू दैट स्टैफिलोकोकस ऑरियस, दैट इज आगंतुज कॉज, एंड टू एस्टैब्लिश द स्ट्रक्चरल स्टेबिलिटी बाय यूजिंग धातु पोषक चिकित्सा, अस्थि एंड मज्जापाचक रस एंड रक्त धातु. दीज वर प्राइम इन ट्रीटमेंट इंटेंशन. सो इन फर्स्ट स्टेज एज आई सेड दैट इज द समीरपन्न कॉम्बिनेशन, अस्थि मज्जापाचक चूर्ण, पुनर्नवाधिगुगुल, ऑल दिस डिक्रीजेस द बैक्टेरियल लोड, रिमूव डेड नेक्रोटिक टिश्यू, दिस ऑगमेंट्स द ब्लड सर्क्युलेशन एंड it stimulates the revascularization at these places by eliminating dosha and removing impurities of the rakta dhatu and decreasing the srotoroda. Vatahara kafara property of these medications, specifically the samirpanna grahas, helpful for the regression of inflammation and avoid further necrosis and reduce ischemia. And so that's why it's ultimately helpful for the rejuvenation of that tibia. All drugs which were used have the capability to address all the manifestation of the vidradi, that is abhyantar vidradi, by penetrating into the biofilms, which I said earlier, which are caused by the Staphylococcus aureus and which are associated with the refractory nature of the chronic osteomyelitis. So combination which was advised, that is Samirpanna combination along with Guduchi Sattva and Sukshma Trifala Gugul, Lakshadi Gugul, Palatrikadi Kath, etc. Lakshadi Gugul repair process triggered by necrotic bone, which included osteoclast. Kaishor Gugul, which was prescribed in the stage 1, it increases vascularity, it induces the Vata Rakta, it pacifies the Vata Rakta Dushtijanya Vikara, and Asti Majja Pachak Churna, that is Guduchi Musta Amalki, acts as a best Shotoshodak for Asti and Majja Dhatu, increases vascularity and formation of osteoclast, and that's why due to Asti Dhatvagni Vardhana, it induces the speedy recovery of that bony lesion. So most of the above mentioned medicine are specifically mentioned for asti sandhigat vikara due to tiktaras and due to sukshma guna. These are helpful for the micros, that is the deep penetration level at microcellular level. Due to tiktaras, it also reduces the kleda and kotha also. By virtue of snigdha guna, balla and bruhan action was occurred. And so all combinedly, all this treatment help in the samprapti vighatana of the asti majja vidradhi. So coming toward again discussion, sarvanga snehan with dhanvantar oil increases blood circulation, relieves edema, congestion and pain, increases range of motion and ultimately results in the pain and tenderness. Local dhara treatment, which was advised by the dhanvantar oil in the stage 2, increases the vascularity to the particular region, and due to application of punarnavadi lepa locally, the swelling was reduced and blackish discoloration was also reduced in this patient, because the content of this punarnavadi lepa, it contains the shotahara and raktaprasadakar property. So this is we will move for the second case, that is contribution of ayurvedic therapy in the management of spinal cord injury induced paraplegia. Actually it was also very challenging case for us. This patient is still our follow up, and he visited every 1 month for the shamana chikitsa. So this is the case of 32 years old male patient. It was belongs to the lower economical class, residing at Akola in Maharashtra. Date of admission, actually he approached in 2016, and still is undergoing intermittent panchakarma chikitsa also. When he approached to our hospital, the chief complaint was weakness in the both lower limb, heaviness in the both lower limb. When he approached to our hospital completely, he brought by her relative on the wheelchair, because he was totally unable to stand and walk independently. There was the loss of bowel and bladder control was also there. Dribbling micturition was there. Incontinence of stool was there. So catheterization, due to that dribbling of micturition, catheterization was also done. Or unable to stand or walk without support, and with support was there. The patient was suffering with all these symptoms since 1 year, that is 1 year and 11 months, that is the 2 years. associated complaint, intermittent constipation, unsatisfactory bowel. Actually, basically, there was no sensation for this patient and lack of appetite. History of present illness, that is, patient was apparently normal before 2 years. But what happened in 2015? There occur history of fall from the tree. Actually, it is, I think, 10 to 12 meter as per history given by the patient. He was complaining severe pain in lumbar region. On that day, patient had no any complaint, just only lumbar pain was there. So he visited to dispensary, analgesic injection was given, but pain was subsided. But on the second day, patient was complaining loss of sensation and weakness in both lower limb, inability to stand with or without support, and continuous dribbling of urine and constipation. Dribbling was started and constipation was also there. You can't imagine, in that patient totally constipation was there for the total duration of 1.5 months. Training was also done, evacuate bladder and bowel when patient approached to us. So he visited to Government Medical College, Akola, and X-ray of lumbosacral spine, MRI was done. At that time, a surgery with transverse pedicular screw fixation under general anesthesia was there, because in MRI finding, there was the wedge shape fracture of the vertebra was there. So that's why he underwent for the surgery particularly. And the surgeon advised that the urine sensation and bowel sensation will appear, and whole sensation to the lower limb will occur slowly within 6 months, as per suggestion by the surgeon. But what happened after surgery? He got mild sensation in the both lower limb, but not able to walk without support, and no bladder control was there. Still, rest of findings of the Ashtavit Parikshana was normal. In neurological examination, there was the spastic gait was there, muscle tone, severe stiffness in both lower limb, rigidity was there in both lower limb, and more rigidity was more in left leg. Generally, in such cases, tingling sensation was there. But patient, in the total duration of 6 months, there was no tingling sensation for the patient. Muscle power grade was second in the left lower limb and grade third in the right lower limb, which was affected. Reflexes, plantar reflexes show dorsiflexion of the greater toe. Knee reflexes show exaggerated reflexes in the left side, and they were normal on the right side. So impaired coordination was there in the movement of both lower limb. Investigation, X-ray of lumbosacral spine, fracture of L5 vertebra. MRI shows L1 traumatic compression wedge fracture with L1 fracture with cord compression, and diffuse mild posterior bulge was also observed at L5 S1 level. USG abdomen was shows post vital volume is not assessed because due to continuous dribbling was there. Rest of USG findings were within normal level. So in Nidana, trauma was the first and chief causative factor in this patient, which ultimately leads to the vitiation of Vata, Rakta and Pitta dosha. Sthanik Vata prakop due to straining and micturition as well as defecation. Constipation motion was not passed since Feb 15, that is for 1 month completely. Aharaj Vishamashan, irregular food habit with excessive intake of pungent food. Pathophysiology of the disease, which can narrate, actually it will be the probable pathology which I considered in that patient. The primary injury results due to the some mechanical force or due to that fall and trauma, which injures the spinal cord, and secondary injury occurs due to the subsequent edema, ischemia, inflammation, and multiple inflammatory markers which were arises at that time, free radical damage.
डॉक्टर पूनम जी आवाज है ना साउंड नहीं आ रही है। डॉक्टर पूनम हेलो, डॉक्टर पूनम
माय पीपीटी इज विजिबल मैम।
हाँ पीपीटी विजिबल है मगर
या
में कुछ हाँ आवाज की डिसकंटिन्यूएशन हो रही है।
अभी अभी यस ओके है ओके ओके। सो डायग्नोसिस ऑफ दिस पेशेंट स्पाइनल कॉर्ड इंड्यूस दैट इज स्पाइनल स्पास्टिक पैराप्लेजिया एंड इन आयुर्वेदिक अकॉर्डिंग टू आयुर्वेदा आई हैव कंसिडर्ड वातनानात्मज व्याधि पंगु व्याधि और अधरांग घाता। सो ट्रीटमेंट वॉज गिवन मेन ट्रीटमेंट प्रिंसिपल ऑफ वात व्याधि एज पर क्लासिकल टेक्स्ट दैट इज स्नेहन स्वेदन एंड मृदु शोधना अलॉन्ग विद दैट वेरियस मोड्स ऑफ स्नेहना थेरेपी आई हैव अप्लाइड इन दिस केस दैट इज सर्वांग स्नेहन विद धन्वंतर ऑयल मज्जा बस्ती दैट इज द द्विपंचमूलादि बस्ती रिकमेंडेड बाय द अष्टांग हृदय शमन स्नेहपाना नित्य मृदु एंड स्निग्ध विरेचना कटिबस्ती दैट इज द टाइप ऑफ स्निग्ध स्वेद। सो इन स्टेज वन अगेन कंसिडरिंग द सामावस्था ऑफ द कंडीशन वी हैव अगेन बायफर्केटेड अवर ट्रीटमेंट इन टू फेज दैट इज स्टेज वन which was for 14 days and stage 2 for rest of 14 days and completely the total admission duration of the patient was 1 month. In panchakarma procedure, we advise sarvanga snehan with dhanvantar oil followed by the patrapottari sveda, generally nirgundi, arka and erandal leaves. Shashti shali pinda sveda after 7 days was started. Eranda muladi basti with anuvasan basti which was started in the first 14 days of the treatment which was replaced by the Dvipanchamuladi Basti which contained Mansaras and Dashmul Kashaya Dhara over lumbar and lower abdominal region which was continued for the 1 month. In stage 2, Sarvanga Snehan with Dhanvantar oil along with Sahacharadi oil, Patrapottali Sved was completely replaced by Shashtishali Pinda Sveda because Patrapottali Sved is the Ruksha Snigdha type of Sved. Initially for the Srota Shodhana purpose to relieve spasm, to relieve swelling, we started Patrapottali. After that, we have started Shashtishali which is completely nutritive in nature which induces Balla and Bruhana. After that, for initial 14 days, we have started Erandamuladi Basti, which is Vata Kapha in nature. It induces Dipan, Pachan and Srotoshodhan also. But Dvipanchamuladi Basti, it is completely Vata Shamak Basti, Bruhan Basti. We can consider it as a Rasayan Basti also. Dashamul Kashaya Dhara over lumbar and lower abdominal region, which followed by intermittent Dhara over the same Kashaya. That is intermittent application of hot and cold Dashamul Kashaya. Kattivasti was also prescribed because trauma was there, Sukha Vaigunya was there. So rectify or address that issue, we have started the Kattivasti also. In Shaman Chikitsa, capsule pyrcinuron, it is the phytopharma, that is a proprietary medicine, was advised in stage 1. Rasna Digugul, Rasna Saptakwat, Chandra Prabhavati, Agni Tundivati, Gandharvaritaki and Bastya Mayanta Ghrut was also started. Bastyamayanta Ghrut at bedtime with lukewarm milk was advised. Agni Tundi Vatti, actually completely it is the Dipan Pachan and considering the Vata predominant nature of that disease, we started Agni Tundi Vatti. Chandra Prabhavati, actually disease resides in the Apana Kshetra. So correct that and there was the continuous dribbling micturition was also there. So to correct that Sroto Vaikunya, Chandra Prabhavati was also started to this patient. In the stage 2, we have started some Balla Bruhan Chikitsa which contains some herbo mineral combinations that is Bruhadwat Chintamani 10 tablet, Trivanga Basma 10 tablet along with Guruchi Sattva and we have made that is 60 doses and we have advised it and prescribed it with Ashwagandha Ghrut after each meal. Trayodashanga Gugul was also given at that time. Maharasnadi Kwatha Chandra Prabhavati was as it is. Vishatindu Pati again it contain Vishatinduka and particularly for the getting the tone of the urinary, improving the tone of the urinary bladder. Sinduvar Eranda Sneha type of Snigdha Virechana was advised. Sinduvar is nothing but the Nirgundi because there was the vertebral, that is the Samprapti was situated at the vertebra, Katigata. So Nirgundi is very much helpful in such cases. Bastya Mayanta Ghrut was advised as a Shamana Snehapana, which was continued as like stage 1. So assessment was done. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल द असेसमेंट ऑफ द पेशेंट वॉज डन बेस्ड ऑन द क्लिनिकल फाइंडिंग्स ऑल्सो एज वेल एज सम गोल्ड स्टैंडर्ड स्केल विच एडवाइस इन द मॉडर्न साइंस. सो द असेसमेंट वॉज डन ऑन द ड्यूअल बेसिस. यू कैन सी हियर द बिफोर ट्रीटमेंट देयर वॉज वीकनेस, हेवीनेस, लॉस ऑफ बॉवेल कंट्रोल, लॉस ऑफ ब्लैडर कंट्रोल, अनेबल टू स्टैंड विदाउट सपोर्ट, ऑल फाइंडिंग एट द एक्सट्रीम लेवल. बट आफ्टर ट्रीटमेंट, that is after 1 month of the therapy, the weakness was also significantly reduced. Heaviness in both lower limb was also significantly reduced. On the first time when we administered the Erandam Uladibasti on the first day, there was no complete administration of enema was became possible, and basti pratyagaman kal was 1 second only. Okay. But for the first time, from the second day onwards, what happened? Enema or basti dravya can remain for 15 to 20 minutes and hold urge for the definition. I think this is the very significant finding which was occurred due to Ayurveda. Actually, there is some apprehension that Ayurvedic treatment doesn't act as an emergency medicine. But this patient who was suffering with all these symptoms since 6 months, after surgery also, all these issues had not solved. But there was the significant finding was observed from the second day onwards of this patient. After 4 to 5 days, catheter was also removed due to stoppage of dribbling, and patient can hold the urine sensation for at least 1 hour also. So I think this is the great achievement in this patient. Then a patient was able to stand without support for a while and can walk with the support. From the third day onward, patient started walking with support with the help of walker. As I said earlier, patient was also assessed with the some specific score system, which are the gold standard parameter in the modern science. That is, it is the modified Barthel index score. You can see here. It is the Shaha version which I have used, self-care assessment, which shows, it reflects actually whether how much extent of dependency of the patient is there. That is the first one, due to that MBI score, before treatment, the score was 31, which get increased to 91, which shows that the dependency of the patient to his relative was significantly reduced, and its slight dependency. It shows that there was the slight dependence due to independent in transfer and able to walk or use crutches independently. At the same time, ma'am, I am audible, na? Okay. At the same time, patient was also assessed by spinal cord independence measure score system. Again, you can see here the previous score was 41, which was again significantly improved to 78 years old. All these score system are available on the PubMed, because these are the standard, these are taken from the standard journal. So you can also use in your patients also. Gait, there was the spastic gait at the initial stage of the condition, but after completion of the treatment for whole 1 month, there was no spastic gait was observed. Muscle tone, which was 4 plus, got reduced to 1 plus. Stiffness and rigidity of both lower limb was reduced in both lower limb. Muscle power, which I have already told, it was second in left lower and third in right lower limb, which is again, it also improved. Reflexes, plantar reflexes to dorsiflexion of the greater toe before treatment, which get which was the same after treatment. Knee reflexes show exaggerated, which shows the brisk reflexes after treatment. Previously, there was couldn't balance himself, but after treatment, there is slightly paired coordination in movement of both lower limb. And now, the current status of the patient is patient can hold his urine for 5 to 6 hours continuously, and till date, no catheterization was done. So, by assessing this, एज पर MBI स्कोर एंड SCIM स्कोर आई वॉज ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड हियर. देर वॉज अ सिग्निफिकेंट इम्प्रूवमेंट इन द स्कोर विच शोज दैट देर इज द सिग्निफिकेंट रिडक्शन इन द डिपेंडेंसी एंड देर वॉज द सिग्निफिकेंट इम्प्रूवमेंट इन द क्वालिटी ऑफ लाइफ ऑफ द पेशेंट. सो कमिंग टू अवर डिस्कशन, द ट्रीटमेंट अडॉप्टेड फॉर दिस पेशेंट वॉज कम्प्लीटली बेस्ड ऑन द ट्रीटमेंट प्रिंसिपल, क्लासिकल ट्रीटमेंट प्रिंसिपल मेन्शन फॉर द वातव्याधि. And because there was the agatach and agantuch hetu was there, so vata, considering the nature of vata janatmach vyadhi, kasharukagat sandhi and asti are the sites of the shleshak kapha and vyan vayu. That's why various modes of snehana therapy was used in this patient. So it can be correlated, this condition can be correlated with the khanja and pangulya or adharangaghat. So in treatment one, amapachan, srotoshodhan, shotahara, to remove up, that's why patrapottali swed, erandamuladi basti, kati basti, dashmul kashaya dhara, palsi neuron, chandra prabha, maharasnadi kwat, gandharvaritaki powder and basthamayanta gruth was prescribed. In stage 2, balya bruhan, nourishing, neuroprotective treatment was advised, sarvanga snehan with dhanvantar oil, shashti shali pinda swed, vipanchamuladi basti, kati basti, bruhat vachintamani combination along with trivanga baswa, trayodashanga gugul and sinduvar eranda was advised. So, sir, what is the role of sarvanga snehan with dhanvantar oil, patrapottali, shashtishali pindasved, anuvasan with dhanvantar oil? Because, all this treatment was advised one by one. And all this treatment, the combined effect of the therapy, it offers strength to the nerve since it contains the dashamula, bala and ashwagandha. Erenda mulani nirvabasti with alternate anuvasan and dhanvantar oil, because basti is the, we are already aware that basti is the prime treatment of vitiated vata dosha. It also corrects the apan vayu also, which is the main pathognomic factor in this patient. It helps to remove the kapha avarana due to the edema and protrusion which occurred in this patient due to trauma. It also acts on the root of vata, that is pakvashaya. And Erenda Muladi Basti induces specifically the Sroto Shodhana due to its Vata Kaphar properties and Gomutra, which is the main Avab Dravya in this Basti. Erenda Muladi Basti was followed by the Dvi Pancha Muladi Basti to give nourishment to that traumatic lesion for early recovery. Anuvasan Basti with Dhanvantar oil, because Dhanvantar oil is the excellent formulation for the Aghatach condition. And in this Basti, we have added some Majja also, Sahacharadi oil also. And this basti was prescribed, as I said earlier, it is mentioned by Arundhata, Dvipanchamuladi basti, the excellent and superior in all nirva basti. And it is the best one for the vata shamana purpose, because it contains dashmula, some amla rasa, amla kanji we have used actually. Aja mansaras was also used. And it is, specificity of this basti is, it contains the trivrutta sneha. That is the, it is the combination of sarpi, vasa and majja. It is the unique utilization of this basti, Dvipanchamuladi basti, and Trivrutta Sneha and Chatusneha. The basic, generally, both type of this Sneha combination are generally used in the Vata predominant condition. So, when bone marrow is generally, according to the modern science also, this various type of lipid formulation contains in the ketogenic diet, generally because it has some neuroprotective nature, and same action is expected in our patient also. Kati basti to give lubrication and strengthening to the affected part, lumbar region due to trauma as well as surgery. Kati basti with dashmul oil was advised. Dashmul oil is excellent vata shamak in nature. Kati basti helps to lubricate the local musculature as well as tissue nearby region to the lumbar region, and it pacifies vata due to its local snehan property, and it has analgesic properties also. Due to the nature of, dashmul oil. Snigdha virechana, for the snigdha virechana, because it is the vata predominant disease, so we have advised only snigdha virechana and not ruksha virechana. So for snigdha virechana purpose, we have used two combination. For stage 1, gandharva haritaki, that is for the mrudu and mrudu virechana. And because in a vata, Vata-vyadhi chikisa siddhanta, mrudu shodhana was advised. And in second stage, sinduvar eranda, as I said earlier, sinduvar eranda is nothing but the nirgundi. So it is the eranda oil, that is castor oil, which is medicated with nirgundi. It is used for as a snigdha virechana. It specifically helpful for the टू ब्रेक द पैथोफिजियोलॉजी ऑफ द डिसीज एंड सो दैट्स व्हाई सिद्ध विरेचना वॉज एडवाइज. दशबुल कषाय धारा एक्चुअली व्हेन आई वॉज इन ओपीडी आई जस्ट क्लिक दैट इज देयर इज नो सेंसेशन फॉर द ब्लैडर. सो जनरली इन फिजियोथेरेपी कंसेप्ट फॉर द स्टिम्युलेशन पर्पज देयर वॉज द यूज ऑफ अल्टरनेटिव हॉट एंड कोल्ड वॉटर फॉर द स्टिम्युलेशन ऑफ सच काइंड ऑफ कंडीशन. सो आई हैव यूज द सेम प्रिंसिपल इन हियर ऑल्सो दैट इज दशबुल कषाय धारा ओवर एबडोमिन एंड लंबर रीजन बिकॉज इंटरमिटेंट दैट इज हॉट कषाय धारा एंड कोल्ड कषाय धारा इंटरमिटेंट यूज द टोटल इट वॉज प्रिस्क्राइब फॉर 20 minutes डेली एंड इट स्टिम्युलेट इट वॉज रियली हेल्पफुल टू स्टिम्युलेट द ब्लैडर टू मेंटेन इट्स टोन एंड डिक्रीज द ऑटोनोमस नेचर वॉज ब्लैडर विच वॉज ऑकर्ड ड्यू टू द ट्रॉमा इन दिस पेशेंट. फॉर शमन स्नेहपाना पर्पज विच इज अ टाइप ऑफ प्रविचारणा ऑल्सो बस्त्या मयंत ग्रुथ एडवाइस बाय द वाग्भटा ट्वाइस 10 grams वी हैव एडवाइस ट्वाइस डेली एट नाइट एट द सेम टाइम एडवाइस इन द स्टेज 1 बिकॉज इट ऑल्सो हेल्पफुल टू करेक्ट द पैथोलॉजी ऑकर्ड ड्यू टू द अपान वायु दुष्टि. इट ऑल्सो इंक्रीजेस द टोन ऑफ ब्लैडर ऑल्सो. जनरली इट इज एडवाइस इन द मल्टीपल मूत्र प्रदोषज विकारा बाय अवर क्लासिकल आचार्य. सो व्हाई वी हैव यूज्ड हियर वेरियस टाइप ऑफ विचारणा ऑफ स्नेहा बिकॉज अभ्यंगा महास्नेह बस्त्या मयंत घृत अश्वगंधा घृत वॉज एडवाइज एज ए अनुपाना फॉर द हर्बो मिनरल कॉम्बिनेशन बिकॉज अश्वगंधा इट इज द न्यूरो प्रोटेक्टिव इन नेचर. 20 स्नेह प्रविचारणा मोस्ट ऑफ द प्रविचारणा वी हैव यूज्ड इन दिस पेशंट. जनरली दिस विचारणा टाइप ऑफ स्नेहा वॉज कैन बी कंपेयर्ड विद द वेरियस किटोजोनिक डायट इन द पेशंट एंड जनरली इट फाउंड एज वेरी न्यूरो प्रोटेक्टिव इन मल्टीपल टाइप ऑफ पेशंट एंड सो दैट्स वाई इट रेड्यूसेस द न्यूरोनल एक्साइटेशन विच वॉज ऑकर्ड ड्यू टू द सेवरल मेकेनिज्म एंड इट ऑल्सो करेक्ट द इनहिबिटेशन ऑफ वेसिकुलर ग्लूटामेट ट्रांसपोर्टर एंड अल्टीमेटली इट इंक्रीज एडिनोसिन लेवल ऑल्सो एंड अगेन इट हेल्पफुल अल्टीमेटली इट हेल्पफुल फॉर द अर्ली रिकवरी ऑफ द न्यूरोनल फंक्शन बाय डिक्रीजिंग इट्स डैमेज एस्पेशली विच वॉज ऑकर्ड इन द स्पाइनल कॉर्ड इंजुरी. सो this we will move forward for the second case that is management of chemotherapy induced side effect in a pancreatic carcinoma with the panchagavya chikitsa. Actually we are already aware the panchagavya I am doing work since 4 to 5 years over the panchagavya chikitsa. Panchagavya chikitsa is nothing but the various formulation which are derived from the 5 product which are obtained from the cow. So generally in a various type of cancer patient, I am routinely prescribing this panchagavya chikitsa. It is basically not only just helpful to correct the pathology of the disease, but also it also reduces or nullify the various side effect of the existing treatment modalities like chemo and radio also. So most of the time, I have observed that if at the time of diagnosis, we have started the panchagavya formulation. Definitely, there will be no any problem occurred with the patient, and he or she can face chemo and radio very well without causing any complication. So, it is a case study of 45-year male patient. Actually, he was one of my relative, which was treated, and his treatment was, I think, we have started in 2015 and 16. I couldn't remember, but patient when approached to us, he was diagnosed as CA for the pancreatic head in 2019. He was advised for chemo and radiotherapy at Tata Memorial Hospital, Mumbai. But after intervention of first chemo, what happened? Patient was complaining severe nausea, severe aversion to food. Constant epigastric pain, vomiting with empty stomach, as well as after event, even one bout of food or water also, there was occurred vomiting. Generally, all these symptoms are occurred due to the chemo, but all these symptoms are also chief features or chief clinical presentation of pancreatic cancer. So there was the intensity or severity of the complaint was increased in this patient, and due to that impaired nutrition, there was the severe weight loss was also there, severe lassitude was there, and even patient couldn't do any his day-to-day activity also. The patient became quite irritant and he completely he was completely denied for undergoing further chemo and radiotherapy. And there was no relief in above symptom after taking the conservative treatment in the allopathic science. And so that's why patient approached for Ayurvedic treatment. Actually, the first consultation of the patient was done on the telephonic only. And Ayurvedic prescription was started from the June 2019. The chief complaint, as I said earlier, with gradations, same. I have took the gradations from the our CCRS research book. There was anorexia. For the detail, you can refer that book. There was the anorexia, which was 5+, epigastric pain, nausea, vomiting with empty stomach also. And after after taking intake of a single bout of food or a single sip of water also. Lassitude, weight loss was there. 6 kg weight loss occur within the 2 months. Constipation was there. That is actually constipation and bleeding per rectum. Both these symptoms was occurred after the completion of the first dose of chemo. And the rest of the above symptoms were since 2 months. History, past medical history, patient was known case of hypertension since 7 to 8 years, and telmikind was going on. Bilateral lower renal calculus and right upper ureteric calculus before 1 year, and patient was on the conservative treatment and hydrotherapy, etc. Weight loss since 2 months. In personal history, patient had mixed diet, especially frequent intake of spicy and non-veg diet with irregular time interval, addiction, smoking daily, and alcohol weekly, thrice was there. All our predisposing factor were present in that patient. Sleep, late night awakening, and awakening late in the morning. So, there was I am audible now, ma'am.
नहीं थोड़ी देर में आवाज चली गई थी जी. अभी अभी audible है जी. कुछ तो दिक्कत है.
आप या सही में?
हाँ जी. इतना कभी नहीं हुआ. अगर आज कुछ है.
Because I am suffering same for the first time. PPT is visible, ma'am, or not?
Visible, visible.
Okay, okay, okay. Shall I continue? Yes, ma'am. Yes, sure. In drug history, there was the telmikind, as I said, regular antihypertensive was going on. In family history, there is no any specific family history related with the cancer was observed in that patient. In general examination, the patient was poor of the condition. General condition of the patient was very poor of febrile, because when we received the phone call, on the second and third day, we visited the patient at Nagpur. And at that time, the general condition of the patient was very poor. He was conscious but irritated, maybe due to that symptoms. There was no ascites, no hepatomegaly, no splenomegaly was there. Severe anemia was there, maybe due to that bleeding piles also. Blood pressure was okay, weight 55. Prakriti of the patient was Vata Pradhan Pittaj. In Ashtavit Parikshan, mala, unsatisfactory, irregular constipation, and some sort of burning sensation was there after the defecation. Mutra was okay. Jiva was niram. This is the significant finding. In spite of the cancer condition, jiva was niram, and akruti was madhyam. So diagnostic assessment was the patient was already done by the oncologist. The CT abdomen shows a heterogeneous enhancing irregular soft tissue mass in the head of pancreas and uncinate process. Histopathology showed grade 2 pancreatic head carcinoma, and all this, no surgical intervention was advised by the oncologist. Actually, this is the pathophysiology of the disease. I think this is, these are the my views. I don't know whether I am wrong or right, because considering this pathophysiology, we have treated that patient. So एडिक्शन ऑफ टोबैको एंड अल्कोहल विच अल्टीमेटली डैमेजेस टू द पैंक्रियाटिक सेल विच कॉजेस एग्रेवेशन ऑफ तिक्त एंड उष्णगिना ऑफ पित्ता अल्टीमेटली स्रोतो वैगुण्य एट द पैंक्रियाज विच लीड्स टू द इम्बैलेंस बिटवीन वात एंड पित्त दोषा विषमाशद वॉज ऑल्सो देयर एज आई सेड इन द पर्सनल हिस्ट्री एक्सेसिव इनटेक ऑफ अनहोलसम डाइट वॉज देयर एंड कीमोथेरपी विच इज द मेन अगेन प्रीडिस्पोजिंग फैक्टर फॉर कॉजिंग दी दैट इज बर्निंग सेंसेशन पाइल्स एंड अदर रिलेटेड साइड इफेक्ट्स सो ऑल दिस सिम्टम डिस्टर्ब्स द अन्नव एंड रसव स्रोतस इरिटेशन ऑकर ड्यू टू द गैस्ट्रिक मिकोसा बिकॉज इन द मेन मल्टीपल कीमोथेरपिटिक एजेंट कॉजेस द इरिटेशन इन द गैस्ट्रिक मिकोसा विच अल्टीमेटली लीड्स टू द अग्निमांड्य डिस्टर्ब द सिक्रेशन ऑफ वेरियस डाइजेस्टिव जूसेस and ultimately it induces the disturbances in the vata and pitta so and all this contributing factor will already made a favorable condition for the patient generally pachak pitta and saman vayu dushti was occurred so that's why there was loss of appetite epigastric pain nausea and weight loss all these symptoms were aggregated so diagnosis of the patient pancreatic head carcinoma but associated with chemo induced side effect was there so only shaman chikitsa that is the treatment plan suggested for this patient that is the combination praval pishti guduchi satva suvarna sutshekhar ras mauktik kamdudha and chandrakala ras all these five medicines were combined make 30 equal doses by adding together and it was advised for in advised with the gogruta plus mishri that is the sharkara which is pitta shamak in nature gogruta because it is already agnidipak also but pitta shamak in nature it has again immunomodulator and antioxidant property also and these doses was started every 3 hourly that is we have started this combination of 5 medicine every 3 hourly avipattikar powder rudu virechana so 10 gram at bedtime was advised for 1 month only shaman snehapana was started with panchagavya ghruta it was advised 5 gram twice daily before food 3 months गोमूत्र अर्क इट इज द कामधेनु दट इज द वन गो अनुसंधान केंद्र एट नागपुर वॉज देयर दिस इज द कामधेनु फार्मसी विच द एक्सलेंट पंचगव्य प्रिपरेशन आज देयर 10 ml वॉज एडवाइज दट इज ट्वाइस डेली एम्प्टी स्टमक विद द डायल्यूशन ऑफ 100 ml ऑफ वॉटर एंड इट वॉज ऑल्सो कंटिन्यूड फॉर 1 month ओनली अगेन आफ्टर दैट आफ्टर दिस ट्रीटमेंट बिकॉज फ्रॉम आफ्टर इनिशिएशन ऑफ ट्रीटमेंट when we started the oral combination every 3 hourly there was a significant improvement in the nausea excessive salivation and irritation so that's why now patient was able to take some liquid food also irritation was also reduced significantly after that panchatikta kshirabasti was started this panchatikta kshirabasti that is 50 ml that is godugdha 25 ml along with panchatikta ghrita 25 ml and it was planned before the day of chemo and alternate 3 basti after 3 days of chemo actually such plan was prescribed for the patient and it was continued 3 months especially his throughout the course of chemotherapy and in between that matra basti with panchagavya ghrita 60 ml once in a week after food was prescribed for this patient it was also prescribed for the whole duration of his chemo the patient was assessed based on the his symptoms also that is before treatment after 15 days of treatment after 3 month and after 6 month anorexia all these symptoms we can see there was a significant reduction in gradation and most of the symptoms like epigastric pain vomiting was also completely subsided after the 15 days from the fourth day onward there occurred the significant improvement in his clinical findings constipation was also subsided totally weight loss which was occurred actually weight loss by 20 kg within 2 months actually occurred but after 15 days sorry there was a significant improvement in weight also so the patient was also assessed for the quality of life of this patient this quality of life scale was advised by the WHO QOL scale specifically for the cancer patient you can see here there was a significant improvement in the score system so you can see April 2029 July 2019 and October 2019 there was a significant इम्प्रूवमेंट इन द क्वालिटी ऑफ लाइफ ऑफ दैट पेशेंट. सो ड्यूरिंग दिस कोर्स ऑफ ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ 6 मंथ हिज टोटल 3 सेटिंग ऑफ कीमोथेरेपी एंड रेडियोथेरेपी ऑल्सो वेज कम्प्लीटेड विदाउट एनी ट्रबल टू द पेशेंट. देर वॉज नो ब्लीडिंग पाइल्स वॉज देयर, नो बर्निंग सेंसेशन वॉज देयर. Moreover, a satisfactory outcome was observed in clinical symptom and quality of life of the patient also. After regular treatment of consecutive 6 months, patient became completely symptom free and in the next PET scan, there was no any significant or abnormal finding like metastasis was observed in this patient. Now, in this case, why we have selected the Panchagavya Chikitsa? I think Panchagavya formulations, these are Pitta Shamak and Vatanulomak nature. Antioxidant nature, possess immunomodulatory properties and carminative properties also, which actually corrects the process of free radical formation, which is the basic or integral step in the carcinoma. The anti-cancer, antioxidant potential of all these Panchagavya products which are used in this patient is already proved by all these authors. Along with that, certain treatment principle was prescribed, that is the combination of the medicine was suggested. Aise medicines humne use kiye jo those who are possessing the agnidipak property, yakrutottejak property, pitta shamak nature, chardigna and rasayana. These are the main treatment principle which were used in this patient. All these factors or all this treatment principle ultimately corrects the pathology of the primary disease, maybe due to by expelling the toxins from intestine and rectifies the health of already injured tissue of pancreas, checks over the free radical process formation due to their antioxidant nature, antimicrobial nature, anti-inflammatory nature, helps in decreasing cytokines and TNF alpha, which is the main inflammatory marker in such type of cancer, and it helps in the natural tumor regression and to relieve the symptom. Simultaneously, it also nullifies or pacifies the side effects which has occurred due to the chemotherapy, maybe due to by protecting the structure and function of pancreas as well as various organ in the GIT, rejuvenating the health of pancreas by reviving the regeneration of new cell, preventing the spread of disease and increases patient survival with improvement in the quality of life of the patient. So, Gomutra Arka, which is the main component, generally prescribe this Gomutra Arka in all cancer patients. Gomutra Arka relieves nausea by decreasing the excess dravaguna of pitta. It corrects the kledak kafadushti due to kafagna property. Because in chardi, there is the dravaguna of pitta is increases. And there was also present the kledak kafadushti also. It improves the appetite due to agnidipak nature and classical references also supports that Gomutra Arka and Gomutra is useful in Granthi and Arbuda due to its kafagna and anti-cancer property. Panchagavya Gruh, this is the very excellent formulation. Generally, we generally use this combination for Shaman Snehapana purpose and for Matravasti also, because cancer patients are generally contraindicated for the Tikshna Shodhana like Vaman and Virechana, that is the classical Vaman and Virechana. And these are also contraindicated for the Shodhan Basti also or Tikshna Basti also. In that scenario, such patient, we can prescribe certain mild form of Panchakarma in such kind of patient. So, this Panchagavya Gruta pacifies the Pitta and Kapha. It enhances the effect of Shaman drug. It checks over the free radical process as a result of antioxidant effect of and anti-cancer properties and the vitamins A, C and E and multiple fatty acid present in this gruta. Panchatikta Kshirabhasti, it brings the Vatanulomana, especially Apanvayu, corrects the constipation, it lubricates the GIT, it is Pitta Shama, Kledahara, Balla, Rasayan property, because due to the additional effect of Panchatikta Gruta, it reduces the inflammation of gastric mucosa induced by chemotherapeutic agent due to their anti-inflammatory and antioxidant properties. Now, the Shaman Chikitsa, what kind of role of Shaman Chikitsa, that is Praval Panchamrut and Kamdodha Mauktik Yukta, which was advised in this patient to take it every 3 hourly. That is, it balances the pitta, controls gastritis induced by the chemotherapeutic agent. Guruchi Sattva, it is the excellent combination. It is useful in Jirna Jwara due to its pitta shamak property. It corrects the Agni Mandya due to its Amahara and Agni Dipak property. It is also Rasayan in nature. It pacifies the vitiated dosha, ड्यू टू इट्स दाहर प्रॉपर्टी कार्मिनेटिव एंड एंटीपायरेटिक प्रॉपर्टी अग्निमांद्य इट करेक्ट्स द अग्निमांद्य एट धातु लेवल ऑल्सो सुवर्ण शेखरा रिलीव्स हाइपर एसिडिटी नॉसिया वोमिटिंग एंड सिम्टम्स ऑफ गैस्ट्राइटिस चंद्रकला रस इट रिड्यूसेस द सिम्टम ऑफ गैस्ट्राइटिस एंड वोमिटिंग ड्यू टू इट्स पित्त शमन प्रॉपर्टी इट इज बल्य बृहना एंड संतर्पण जन्य ऑल्सो बिकॉज द चंद्रकला रस वॉज एडवाइस विद द दाढ़ीमावलेहा दाढ़ीमावलेहा अगेन इट इज पित्त शामक इन नेचर अविपत्तिकर चूर्णा इट वी हैव यूज इट इज एक्चुअली मृदु फॉर्म ऑफ विरेचना इट स्मूथली क्लियर्स द लार्ज एंड स्मॉल इंटेस्टाइन विदाउट इंड्यूसिंग एनी एक्सेसिव वीकनेस ड्यू टू द दैट इज द सुख विरेचक प्रॉपर्टी इट ऑल्सो एक्टिवेट्स द लिवर गॉल ब्लैडर स्प्लीन पैंक्रियाज एंड इंड्यूसेस देयर प्यूरिफिकेशन रिज्यूविनेशन ऑल्सो एंड रिस्टोरेशन ऑफ देयर फंक्शन बाय देयर पित्त प्रसादन प्रॉपर्टी सो दिस इज द probable mode of action which of the treatment or medication which I have prescribed in this carcinoma patient. Our fourth case is the role of collaborative approach of panchakarma and shaman chikitsa in management of chronic pancreatitis. Actually she was the adolescent girl. Generally pancreatitis it is a very common entities in adult stage specifically in male but generally in childhood pancreatitis it is not a very common one but this patient was very unique case it is a single case study it is a 5 years old female patient female child who was approached according to her statement the patient was apparently normal before 2 years suddenly she developed acute pain in epigastric region which was get aggravated after intake of fatty food and got relieved after bending forward which is a typical feature of the pancreatitis after hospitalization for 3 days she was diagnosed as acute pancreatitis and was advised to take conservative treatment for 1.5 months however between this period what happened she had recurrent attack of similar symptoms and that's why she her relatives have to get her hospitalized recurrently actually for 3 times and the pain has no specific periodicity there was a very irregular pain was there so she did not get satisfactory relief even after the conservative treatment suggested by the physician and therefore she advised for the ERCP which is the standard treatment for the pancreatitis but patient and her relative was not completely willing for this such kind of intervention so that's why they approached to us for the ayurvedic management when patient approached to me there was a recurrent episode of pain in epigastric region recurrent attack especially after intake of fatty or heavy meal tenderness was there in epigastric region loss of appetite was there fever on and off there general malaise loss of weight constipation which was intermittent in nature patient was quite anxious and uncomfortable because there was twin baby was there one baby was completely healthy and this baby was suffering with pancreatitis so multiple time due to that pain and hospitalization there was the complete loss of her school so at the time of result there was the severe comparison between that twin so there she was completely anxious and mental irritation was also there all this the patient was suffering with all these symptoms since 4 months in the history the birth history twin delivery history of incubation for 20 days due to the low weight malnutrition maybe due to the twin pregnancy past history history of recurrent hospitalization since 4 months history of pneumonia at the age of 3 years history of rat bite at the age of 4 years of the age weight loss since 4 months no history of significant surgical illness no history of trauma drug no history of any stone mumps or varicella I have put here because trauma certain drugs gallstone mumps and varicella these are the main causative factor for causing the pancreatitis especially juvenile pancreatitis but no such kind of any factor was observed in the history for causing pancreatitis in this patient so I have decided it may be idiopathic in origin in personal history diet mixed diet was there sleep was sound no history of any allergies or consumption of any drug or scorpion bite because scorpion bite is also one of the causative factor for getting pancreatitis so but such type of history was not also found in this patient in family history mother history of enteric fever एट द फर्स्ट ट्राइमेस्टर ऑफ प्रेगनेंसी इट वॉज एंड शी वॉज मैनेज्ड विथ ओरल एंटीबायोटिक. दिस इज द सम मैटरनल साइड ऑफ हिस्ट्री विच आई हैव फाउंड इट मे बी रिलेटेड विद द दिस क्लिनिकल कंडीशन इन द बेबी. इम्यूनाइजेशन हिस्ट्री, इम्यूनाइज एट गवर्नमेंट हॉस्पिटल एज पर शेड्यूल. Investigation and previous treatment protocol I have put here in chronological order. You can see serum lipase, actually these are usually raised in pancreatic condition. Serum amylase, which was also raised. Hemoglobin, patient was anemic, 9.7 gram per dl was there. In CT, there was ill-defined non-enhancing hypodense area in tail of pancreas with surrounding inflammatory changes, which suggests that focal necrotic pancreatitis involving the tail of pancreas, and few small areas of necrosis also noted in the neck of pancreas. And specifically, this is the standard treatment in the modern science which was undergoing, which was continued for the patient. And patient was advised for high fiber diet, and there was the complete ban for the fatty food. Patient was advised ERCP and further after further attack. And the patient and relative was completely unwilling for the same. Hospitalization 2 times between fortnight, conservatively managed, and their conservative treatment was ongoing for the patient. But in January 2017, Ayurvedic treatment was started for the patient. And in May 2018, the Ayurvedic treatment was stopped for this patient. In examination, chief clinical examination, pallor was there, hemoglobin was 9.7. Icterus not there, any no lymphadenopathy was there. Weight of the patient 13.9 kg. Normally us age mein, that is at the time of that age, the weight should be 17.9 kg. Height should be age or weight, both are low as per the standard format or standard age. So totally malnutrition was there in that patient. On palpation, per abdomen, on the palpation, slightly distended abdomen was there. Tenderness was present in the epigastric region, which is the very common feature. Muscle guard and rigidity in epigastric region was also present. These are all pathognomic signs are present in the pancreatic, specifically the chronic pancreatitis patient. No Murphy's sign was negative, fluid thrill absent, no rebound tenderness was there, and no organomegaly was there. On percussion, tympanic note was present, shifting dullness present. On auscultation, bowel sound present, but other systematic examination was normal in this patient. In Ashtavit Parikshan, mala asamyak, mutra samyak, jivha sam, akruti krush. Diagnosis, I have diagnosed here agnyashay vikruti janya grahani with jirna jvara, that is juvenile chronic necrotizing pancreatitis. So the treatment plan decided for the patient, shodhan purva dipan pachana, syrup anarmix was given, that is it is contained completely, dadim is the main content of this patient, combination. This is Nagarjun pharmacy, 5 ml before each meal with lukewarm water for 15 days. After that, sasneha nirvabasti with panchatikta kshira was advised for this patient, that is 250 ml cloth, which is made up of guduchi, vasa, nimba, patol, kantakari, that is panchatikta, which are mentioned in classics. And along with that, dhanvantar ghruta and panchakta tikta ghruta was added as a sneha, each 10 ml, honey 5 gram and sendo 2.5 gram. This basti was started. 2 nirva basti was planned, followed by 1 anuvasan basti with dhanvantar tel. And all this treatment protocol was continued for consecutive 15 days. After that, guduchadi nirva basti, that is guduchi, nimba, dashmul, ashwagandha, mustakwat, dhanvantar tel, 20 ml. Actually, this is not a classical reference, but I have used here. 2 nirvabasti followed by 1 anuvasan basti with dhanvantar tel. It was also continued for further 15 days. So, and for internal administration, arogya vardhini vatti, amrutottar kashaya considering the jirna jvara and dhatvagni mandya, amrutottar kashaya with dhanvantar kashaya was started. Chandraprabha Vati prescribed Avipattikar Churna, Tripala Gugul, because it is anti-inflammatory in nature. Panchatikta Ghrut with Dhanvantar Ghrut. Actually, according to modern science, fat is totally restricted in such type of cases. But after correcting हिज अग्नि और मंदाग्नि और करेक्टिंग हिज सामावस्था वी कैन स्टार्ट द पंचतिक्त घृत विद धन्वंतर घृत इच 2.5 ग्राम बिडी विथ लुकॉम वॉटर वसंत कुसुमाकर रस दैट इज वी हैव स्टार्टेड सर्टन कॉम्बिनेशन वसंत कुसुमाकर रस कुड़ुची सत्व एंड अश्वगंधा चूर्ण टोटल 50 डोसेस वॉज प्रिपेयर्ड एंड इट वॉज एडवाइज फॉर द इट वॉज एडवाइज विद द लुकॉम मिल्क आफ्टर फूड फॉर 3 months आफ्टर 3 months दिस कॉम्बिनेशन वॉज स्टॉप द पेशंट वॉज अगेन असेस्ड बेस्ड ऑन द सिम्टोमेटिक मैनेजमेंट यू कैन सी हियर The patient was assessed after 6 months and after 1 year and 4 months. Actually, in the initial day, that is up to the 6 months, patient was giving follow-up every 1 month. Okay. But after that, when there was no any significant symptom or the severity of the symptom got reduced, the patient was advised to give follow-up every 2 months. So you can see here all these symptoms were totally subsided after the 1 year and 4 month treatment. So after regular treatment for consecutive 16 months, patient was become completely symptom free. Till date, there was no need for hospitalization after starting Ayurvedic treatment, no any educational loss between this treatment. And till date, patient is not visiting us now, but before 2 and 4 months, her one relative approached me for some Sandhivat treatment. She tell me that patient is totally symptom free now. Menarche was occurred very smoothly and there is no any symptom. Significant finding is that there was a significant in weight gain also. So all these miraculous result was observed in this patient. So we can see the main treatment principle applied, that is Shodhan and Mrudu Virechan, Dipan Pachan, Jirna Jwarahara Chikisa was applied. For that purpose, we have used that is Amrutottar Kashaya and Dhanvantar Kashaya, which induces Pachana at digest Jatharagni level and Dhatvagni level also, which occurred due to the Agni Mandya. Rasayan Chikisa, which was started as a Shamana Snehapana, Panchatikta Ghritapana and Dhanvantar Ghrita. It checks over free radical formation and ultimately it reduces the inflammation of pancreas. Shamana and Bruhan Snehapana again nourishes Rasayan, Medadhatu. A pramehagna action, because when pancreatic cell get damages, definitely it will converted into the prameha. So a pramehagna principle was also applied. That's why we have used the panchatikta formulation here. And all these due to the pancreatic protective nature of that panchatikta formulation, we used it induces the pramehagna action. It rejuvenates the pancreas. It restored its functioning and reduces the swelling. Yakrutottejak Arogyavardhini was given, serum anaramix was given, elevates the digestion of fat by increasing the secretion of bile. So, combined action of therapy may be the treatment principle, that is Tikshnoshna Pitta or Pittaj Gulma. Actually, I have treated this patient at Pittaj Gulma, Avrutta Saman Vata, especially Vata Pitta Shamak, Laghu. But Santarpan Chikisa was adopted in this patient. The all treatment principle, all treatment medication may be acts as all this treatment medication may possess anti-inflammatory, antimicrobial, and antioxidant potential. So that's why the checks over the free radical formation, which are responsible for inflammation in the pancreas. It elevates the digestion of fat by increasing the secretion of bile. And by making the liver competent for the same, it reduces pain and swelling in pancreas. It helps in decreasing cytokines, TNF, which are inflammatory marker, helps in PPRY, which is the main anti-inflammatory action of the cell. It reduces inflammation up to the great extent and it rejuvenates the health of pancreas. Ultimately, it improves the digestion. And in nutshell, it expels the toxin from the intestine and rectifies the health of already injured tissue of the pancreas. So, these are the whole probable mode of action of treatment protocol which I have prescribed in this chronic pancreatic adolescent girl. The last case is the management of pemphigus foliacus, that is, which is a common autoimmune disorder through Ayurveda. Actually, generally, certain autoimmune disorders are self-limiting or they have no existing treatment modalities in the contemporary science. So there is a very great challenge for all of us to create or to टू ट्रीट सच काइंड ऑफ पेशेंट बिकॉज जनरली इन सच काइंड ऑफ ऑटोइम्यून डिसऑर्डर देर आर चांसेस ऑफ रिकरेंस ऑफ द डिसीज ऑल्सो. जनरली इन सच काइंड ऑफ ऑटोइम्यून डिसऑर्डर जनरली स्टीरॉयडल ट्रीटमेंट आर प्रिस्क्राइब्ड बट विच हैव सर्टन लिमिटेशन ड्यू टू इज साइड इफेक्ट और सच काइंड ऑफ ट्रीटमेंट इज स्पेसिफिकली कॉन्ट्राइंडिकेटेड इन मल्टीपल पेशेंट्स ऑल्सो. So considering the limitation of all these existing treatment modalities for such kind of autoimmune disorder, it is really the need of our to find out some alternative or alternative safe and effective management in the Ayurveda. So this is my try for making such to establishing such kind of treatment in autoimmune disorder. This pemphigus folliculitis, it is a single case study of 35 years old male patient because he was suffering with fluid filled blister over the both palm region. Itching was there, burning sensation was there, and severe discomfort while performing regular tasks. You can see the picture. That is at this finger, at this thumb, you can see here the multiple boils also. There is the irregularity in the mucosa, over the skin. And there is complete some erosion was also there. And that's why there was the burning sensation, itching. Sometime discharge was also occurred. And so the such kind of infection or lesion can observed in all fingers of the hand. And there is the recurrent, there is the subsidal rate is also fast and recurrence rate is also fast in this patient. So the patient had complaint, all these aforesaid complaints was there since past 4 months. So he underwent allopathic treatment first and specific topical and internal medication, that is Rovate, gentamicin cream, antibiotic and steroids was given. But this symptom subsided temporarily. Due to the application and administration of all these symptoms, all symptoms get subsided. But after reoccurred after stoppage of therapy. And this was going on after the 3 cycles of the antibiotic. So that's why he was seeking for the alternative options. Moreover, patient was received homeopathic medication also for the same. But there was no satisfactory relief after taking 2.5 months of the therapy. Therefore, he approached to our hospital, Mahatma Gandhi Ayurveda Hospital, for the further Ayurvedic management. In past history, there was no significant history related to the disorder was noted. No any family history was also observed regarding this autoimmune disorder. In personal history, totally diet, he was taking Jain food, vegetarian, daily intake of curd and pickle. So maybe it may lead to rakta and pitta provoking food items because he was consuming since many years. Vihar. Atyasana was there because he was the software engineer in China. Atyasana was there. And micturition normal, no history of any addiction, sleep was sound. So you can see when we have done the local examination, that is inspection, you can see the type of rash is, this is the vesical type of rash. Certain blisters are there. Color and size and shape, that is reddish, less than 0.5 centimeter and it is the circumscribed rash. Okay, crust formation is there and dried exudate was also there. On palpation, elevation, raised and palpable blister was there. And these are present over the all fingers, specifically over the nail beds. And Nicolsi sign found was positive, which is the unique feature of this kind of autoimmune disorder. Tenderness, pain and burning sensation was there. And due to that, patient can't do his household duties also. Surface texture was hypokeratic lesions. When first time patient was approached to the skin specialist, some certain skin biopsy was done in April 2020, which shows that hyperkeratosis, parakeratosis and intraepidermal blister above the basal layer of stratified squamous epithelium in the skin. The granular skin is affected, showing acantholytic keratinocyte and mild micronuclear inflammatory infiltrate. And the deeper dermis also shows mild mononuclear inflammatory infiltrate because it is the autoimmune disorder. Certain kind of pathological changes are expected in this scenario. And so he suggested that there may be the pemphigus folliculosis. So द स्किन स्पेशलिस्ट हैड डन सच काइंड ऑफ डायग्नोसिस एंड एडवाइस एंटीबायोटिक अलॉन्ग विद सम स्टेरॉइड्स. इन अष्टविध परीक्षण ऑफ दिस पेशेंट नाड़ी वॉज पित्त प्रधान एंड नियमित मल असम्यक वंस डे बट नॉट सेटिस्फेक्टरी बट प्रॉपर कंसिस्टेंसी. मूत्र असम्यक 5 to 7 टाइम्स डेली बट रिकरंट बर्निंग सेंसेशन वॉज देअर. जीवा वॉज साम थ्रूप शब्द वॉज स्पष्ट रेस्ट ऑफ फाइंडिंग्स वेअर नॉर्मल. मे बी इन सच काइंड ऑफ निदाना द स्पेसिफिकली विच इज ऑब्जर्व इन दिस पेशंट डेली इनटेक ऑफ कर्ड पिकल विरुद्ध आहार मंदाग्नि सिटिंग फॉर ए लॉन्ग अवर दैट इज अत्यासना मे लीड टू द विशेषण ऑफ पित्ता अफेक्टिंग वात एंड कफ साइमल्टेनियसली विच अल्टीमेटली स्प्रेड्स टू द तिर्यगत सिराज रक्त मान इट इंड्यूसेस द रक्त मांसत्व लसिका दृष्टि विच अल्टीमेटली क्रिएट्स द स्रोतोवैगुण्य और स्थान संश्रय इन त्वका एंड स्मॉल टाइप ऑफ ब्लिस्टर कंटेनिंग फ्लूइड फॉर्म ओवर पाम रीजन वॉज ऑब्जर्व विच लीड्स टू द विस्फोटा. तो आई थिंक दिस सच काइंड ऑफ ऑटोइम्यून डिसऑर्डर दैट इज पेम्फिगस कैन बी कोरिलेटेड विद द विस्फोटा. दिस इज द प्रोबेबल संप्राप्ति. द शोधन चिकित्सा विच आई हैव प्रिस्क्राइब दिस पेशेंट दैट इज फर्स्ट प्रियर एनी काइंड ऑफ शोधन चिकित्सा वी जनरली स्टार्टेड दीपन पाचना. इन दिस पेशेंट दीपन पाचना वॉज कैरिड आउट विथ आम पाचकवटी 2 tablets पीडी बिफोर इच फूड विच वॉज एडवाइज फॉर कॉन्जिक्यूटिव 3 days विच वॉज फॉलोड बाय द आरोही स्नेहपाना दैट इज प्लेन काउ घी गोवर्धन कंपनी घी वॉज स्टार्टेड इन अ इंक्रीमेंटल ऑर्डर दैट इज स्टार्टेड फ्रॉम द 30 ml डोज एंड डेली इंक्रीज ऑफ द 30 ml डोज. इट वॉज कंटिन्यूड फॉर कॉन्जिक्यूटिव 6 months दैट इज 4th to 9th डे. आफ्टर दैट बाह्य स्नेहना वॉज एडवाइज फॉलोड बाय द नाडी स्वेदना एंड इट वॉज एडवाइज फॉर द 2 days दैट इज ऑन द 10th एंड 11th डे and on the 12th day virechana was prescribed to the patient and for that purpose trivrutta leha kotakkal pharmacy 80 to 100 grams was prescribed for the patient with lukewarm water which was advised at 9:30 a.m. and with empty stomach and total 10 vegas were observed but kafanta darshana was there that is samyak virechana was observed in this patient which was patient was advised for the sansarjana krama for 3 days only. After that, after performing the shaman chikitsa, sansarjan krama completely, patient was shifted over the shaman chikitsa, which consists of Keshwar Gugul, 250 mg, 3 tablets TDS with lukewarm water after each meal, avipattikar powder, 10 gram HES at bedtime as a mrudu virechana, rakta shodha kwat of Unza pharmacy was prescribed for consecutive 2 months, gandhak rasayan, along with that panchatikta ghruta gugul dhut papeshwar was prescribed 3 tablets TDS after each meal and amrut rajanyadi kashaya that is CNS chikitsalayam pharmacy which was advised 50 ml with equal quantity of lukewarm water and it was prescribed at 7 am to 5 pm. All this treatment was prescribed for continue 2 months. The patient was assessed symptomatically and the basis of the clinical images also you can see that is itching, burning sensation, secretion and nature of the blister. You can see there was a significant finding before treatment and after treatment that is after the completion of shamana chikitsa. So you can see the picture before treatment and after treatment. That after completion of the treatment the encouraging observations obtained in this patient. Clinical features such as oozing, pain, burning sensation, itching was also subsided completely after the 2 months of the therapy. Till date, no recurrence was. Patient is undergoing virechana in Charatu. So, this is I think maybe seasonal purification also arrests recurrence of the disease in this patient. This pemphigus folliculosis is a very acquired autoimmune skin disorder which is characterized by the fluid-filled blister, itching and burning sensation. It can be correlated with the visphota in the Ayurveda, maybe due to the abhishandi gunatmak virudha ahar vihar, maybe due to the faulty lifestyle also. So, in Ayurveda, this visphota consists of the predominance of kapha and pitta dosha. So, generally, the kapha and pitta alleviating treatment was selected for this patient. The probable mode of action of shaman chikitsa that is Keshwar Gugul, it increases the blood flow because due to the rakta prasadakara nature, it increases the blood flow and balances pitta due to its anti-inflammatory vasodilation and blood cleansing property. इट ब्रेक्स द पैथोजेनेसिस ऑफ द डिजीज ड्यू टू इट्स एंटी अर्थराइटिक एंटी ऑक्सीडेंट एनाल्जेसिक अडेप्टोजेनिक एंड एंटी बैक्टेरियल प्रॉपर्टी. अविपत्ति कर चूरना इट स्केलेट द म्यूकस सिक्रेशन एनिमिनेट टॉक्सिट इट इंड्यूसेस द मृदु विरेचना डेली विरेचना ड्यू टू इट्स लैक्सेटिव प्रॉपर्टी. इट एनहांसेस द डिफेंसिव मैकेनिज्म ऑफ द गैस्ट्रिक म्यूकोसा ड्यू टू मे बी साइटोप्रोटेक्टिव प्रॉपर्टी एंड एंटी अल्सर प्रॉपर्टी एक्सर्टेड बाय द हरितकी मरीच एंड पिपली. एंड द लवंगा इन द अविपत्तिकर चूर्ण फैसिलेट द बेसल गैस्ट्रिक म्यूकोसल ब्लड फ्लो. द पंचतिक्त घृत गुग्गुल ऑफ धूतपापेश्वर कंपनी वॉज प्रिस्क्राइब फॉर द पेशेंट. इट स्टेबिलाइजेस द मांस धातु एंड फर्दर पैथोजेनेसिस ऑफ द त्वकदृष्टि इन दिस पेशेंट विच अल्टीमेटली करेक्ट्स द ब्लिस्टर. इट एक्ट्स एज अ रिजुविनेटर ऑफ द स्किन ड्यू टू इट्स वात पित्त शामक पल्य रसायन एंड वयस्थापक प्रॉपर्टी. इट ऑल्सो इंक्रीजेस द धात्वग्नि ड्यू टू द तिक्त रसा एंड कटु विपाका एंड उष्णविरिया. सो इट डिक्रीजेस द बर्निंग सेंसेशन इरिटेशन ड्यू टू इट्स दाह प्रशमन प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ द तिक्त रस. अमृतरजन्यादि कषाय विच वॉज प्रिस्क्राइब इन दिस पेशंट इट रेड्यूसेस द इचिंग बर्निंग सेंसेशन हिस ब्लिस्टर ड्यू टू इट्स प्रणशोधक एंड रोपन प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ इट्स वॉटर सोल्यूबल फाइटोकेमिकल्स. इट इंडिकेटेड दैट्स वाई इट इज इंडिकेटेड इन शीत मल्टीपल स्किन कंडीशन लाइक शीतपित्ता विष कृमि कुष्ठ एंड कंडू. द रक्तशोधक काढ़ा रेड्यूसेस द कंडू दाह विस्फोट ड्यू टू इट्स रक्तशोधक प्रणरोपक त्वच प्रॉपर्टी कृमिघ्न प्रॉपर्टी हिपेटोस्टिमुलेंट हिमेटिनिक प्रॉपर्टी. इट रिमूव्स द इम्प्यूरिटीज ऑफ द ब्लड. द रोल ऑफ शोधन चिकित्सा बिकॉज इन दिस पेशेंट विरेचना इज द प्राइम ट्रीटमेंट. जनरली विरेचना विथ त्रिवृत्त लेहा करेक्ट्स द विशेषण ऑफ पित्ता विच इज मेनली हेल्प टू ब्रेक द पैथोजेनेसिस ऑफ द डिजीज. इट ऑल्सो चेक्स ओवर सर्टन ऑटोइम्यून रिस्पॉन्सेज विच ऑकर्ड बाय करेक्टिंग द मेटाबोलिज्म इन द बॉडी एंड ड्यू टू मे बी ड्यू टू इट्स in the blister size and there also reduction in the itching also. So cumulative effect of therapy balances the vitiated dosha and breaks the pathogenesis of the disease by the raktashodhak property maybe due to natural blood cleansing property and stabilizes the mansa dhatu decreases the twakadushti leading to the better improvement in the clinical condition that is the symptomatic management. Deepan, rasayan and anti-inflammatory properties of this medication are also contributing factor for the speedy recovery of the lesion in this patient. And the seasonal purification, which is already emphasized by our class acharyas, which also helpful to avoid the recurrence of the disease in this condition. So, these are the different cases which I have shared with you. Now I think if there are any query or any discussion regarding these cases, I think platform is open. Thank you very much for giving me such a nice opportunity for sharing my views and sharing my this case on this virtual and national platform. So thank you Hetal ma'am. These are the references which I have used here for making this presentation. These are some my publications on different topics. So I think platform is open for a discussion. Thank you very much.
वंदे भारत वाली स्पीड पर और एक्स्ट्रा ऑर्डिनरी है. बहुत सारे पार्टिसिपेंट्स इसकी सराहना कर रहे हैं और मैं समझती हूँ कि यूट्यूब ऊपर अपलोड होगा तो बहुत सारे आगे ऊपर भी अनेक लोग उसका फायदा उठा पाएंगे, उससे बेनिफिट्स ले पाएंगे और बहुत सारे रोगियों को रोग से मुक्त कर पाएंगे.
बहुत कि ये ज्यादा से ज्यादा आयुर्वेदा के मिरेक्युलस रिजल्ट है पहुंचने चाहिए ताकि ग्लोबली वो एक्सेप्टेबल हो.
जी जी बिल्कुल सही कह रहे हैं. इस मंच का भी डॉक्टर प्रदीप सर ने जब 21 नवंबर 2015 को पहला सेशन हुआ तब यही एक उद्देश्य से किया था और मैं आज आज के लेक्चर में बाय चांस ही मैं कहीं बीच बीच में याद किया करती हूँ सभी पार्टिसिपेंट्स और सभी व्याख्यानकर्ता को कि जिन्होंने समर्पित भाव से इस ज्ञान यज्ञ में आहुति दी और जिसके कारण ये अनवरत 90 साल भी चल रहा है.
Yes, it is the great achievement, ma'am.
नहीं, आप जैसे लोग साथ बेटा निभा देते हैं वरना बंद हो जाता.
नहीं नहीं, ऐसे ही कंटिन्यू रहेगा और आगे चलना चाहिए क्योंकि उसी से आयुर्वेद आगे बढ़ेगा.
जी जी, बिल्कुल बिल्कुल. और मैं समझती हूँ कि जो इनिशियल भाव रहा ना कि निःशुल्क और कंटिन्यूस विदाउट एनी ब्रेक, तो ये कहीं ना कहीं बहुत सारे लोग उससे ऊर्जावान बनते हैं और इससे बहुत अच्छी अपनी चिकित्सकीय सोच को सुदृढ़ बना सकते हैं. तो सच में बहुत ही बढ़िया आपका लेक्चर था और मुझे लगता है कि बहुत लोगों को आगे भी उपयोगी बनेगा ये. मैंने अनम्यूट कर दिया है, किसी को पूछना है तो एक बार अपना माइक अनम्यूट करके पूछ सकते हैं. तब तक मैं आपके लिए, किस किस ने बहुत बढ़िया कहा है, वंडरफुल सेशन, डॉक्टर माधुरी, डॉक्टर अनुराधा, डॉक्टर फाइजर, डॉक्टर मनदीप कौर, डॉक्टर अनुराधा, डॉक्टर लीना कारेकर, बहुत सारे अच्छा हाँ, अनुराधा जी ने और भी एक कहा है, डॉक्टर अनिल कुमार, अवेशम लेक्चर. अनुराधा जी कह रहे हैं कि प्लीज अरेंज मोर सेशंस, तो लोगों की प्यास और बढ़ा दी आपने. डॉक्टर प्रियंका वर्मा, वेरी
डेफिनेटली मैम, जरूर ट्राई करेंगे.
सुपर लेक्चर डॉक्टर चंद्रकला, और सुपर फास्ट ऑल्सो, यस उन्होंने भी वही नोट किया है. और डॉक्टर युक्ति जैन, बेटा आप चैट बॉक्स देखेंगे, युक्ति जैन ने कुछ लिखा है.
यस मैम,
डॉक्टर अंजना, डॉक्टर मनिंद्रा मोहन, बहुत सारे लोगों ने उसकी वो सराहना की है.
यस मैम, आई विल चेक.
जी डॉक्टर युक्ति जैन पूछ रही है, आई हैड क्वेरी रिगार्डिंग द पैंक्रियाटिक कैंसर केस, व्हाई वेयर द मेडिसिंस गिवन वेरी फ्रीक्वेंटली लाइक इन एवरी 3 आवर्स.
यस मैम, बिकॉज व्हाट हैपन इन दिस पेशेंट, यू कैन सी देयर वाज द दुष्टि ऑफ क्लेदक कफा एंड पाचक पित्ता, एंड इन कंप्लेंट्स आई हैव ऑलरेडी शेयर्ड There was the nauseatic feeling and vomiting sensation was there even after taking the one bout of the food or one sip of the water. Okay, so it is quite irritant for the patient. And to pacify all these symptoms, जैसे मुहुर मुहु, औषध काल जो बताए है हमारे शारंगधर ने, उसमें एक मुहुर मुहु वाला कंसेप्ट है. That means if the severity of the vishesan of dosha is more, in that scenario, we have advised the medicine that is muhur muhu. That's why I have kept the that combination after 3 hours. Because patient ऐसे नहीं था कि दो गोलियां निगल ली और हो गया, क्योंकि हमें भी पता है कि एक सिप लिया को मीटिंग करने वाला है. तो आई हैव प्रिस्क्राइब डोज मेडिकेशन विद दाढ़ी मावलेह, दैट इज फॉर द लीकिंग पर्पज. तो उससे क्या होता था कि उसका सबलिंगुअल एब्सॉर्प्शन भी अच्छे से होता है और थोड़ी थोड़ी देर के बाद रहे है तो एक पर्टिकुलर एक ब्लड लेवल में उसकी जो मेडिसिन की एक लेवल हमें मेंटेन करनी है ताकि जो विशिएटेड दोषों की जो एक्सट्रीम कंडीशन है वो सबसाइड कर सके. ओके, सो दैट्स वाई उस औषध काल की उपाय योजना हमने उसके लिए की है ताकि हम उसके सिवियरिटी सिम्टम्स को सबसाइड कर सके. क्योंकि आफ्टर 7 डेज हमने इंटेंसिटी उसकी कम कर दी, वही नहीं रखा, मुहर मुंह नहीं रखा, उसको हमने टीडीएस कर दिया. ओके,
बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद. अच्छा, किसी डॉक्टर को कुछ क्वेरी है, प्रश्न है तो अपना अनम्यूट माइक करके पूछ सकते हैं. शायद किसी का हैंड रेज अभी मैंने देखा था, नहीं है, नहीं है, बस ऐसे ही दिखा था शायद.
ओके, अगर फिर भी अगर क्वेरीज है मैम अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट, ऐसे जरूरी नहीं है कि अभी इसी सेशन में पूछा जाए, नो इशू. आई एम शेयरिंग माय मोबाइल नंबर आल्सो, इफ एनीवन हैव एनी क्वेरी. ऐसे नहीं हो सकता कि बाद में हमें कुछ पेशेंट ट्रीट कर रहे हैं, ठीक है, तो उसमें भी दिक्कत आ सकती है. तो दे कैन आस्क मी विदाउट एनी हेजिटेशन, दे कैन पुट मी मैसेज ऑल्सो, और मेरा एक थोड़ा सा एक रिक्वेस्ट बोलो आपको, अगर ये कुछ ट्रीट करते समय, क्योंकि मैं भी अभी सीख रही हूँ, अगर इसमें अभी कुछ मेरी गलती है कि नहीं मैम आपने ऐसे नहीं करना है, ओके, तो देर आर सम सजेशंस ऑल्सो, देर इज मल्टीपल स्कोप फॉर द बेटरमेंट ऑफ अवर द ट्रीटमेंट मोडालिटीज, ओके, उस अगर आपके कुछ सजेशन वो भी इस नंबर पे आप सजेस्ट कर सकते हो मुझे कि मैम इसको आप और अच्छा बेटर बना सकते थे, ठीक है, क्योंकि हर कोई परफेक्ट नहीं होता है ना, देयर इज द वाइड चांस फॉर द इम्प्रूवमेंट, तो ऐसे भी सजेशंस है, तो आप प्लीज आप मुझे दे आप आपसे मुझे एक्सपेक्टेड है कि आप ऐसे भी मुझे सजेशंस दो।
जजेस थे उसको भी धन्यवाद है, सही बंदे को दे रहे हो।
थैंक यू मैम,
तो
थैंक यू।
जीवन भर विद्यार्थी बने रहना आगे बढ़ने की बहुत बड़ी सीढ़ी है, ऐसा मुझे अपने जीवन में लगा कि
सही में मैम।
बार-बार सीखने की तमन्ना हमें बहुत ऊपर उठाती है और एक अभ्यंतर खुशी भी होती है जो पैसे पुसे से नहीं आती है, तो
रियली
मुझे लगता है कि बिल्कुल सही है। विश्व आयुर्वेद परिषद के इस प्लेटफॉर्म से मैं आपका तहे दिल से बहुत बहुत हार्दिक हार्दिक धन्यवाद करती हूँ कि
थैंक
आप
यू मैम, थैंक
हमारे
यू।
रिक्वेस्ट पर यहाँ आए और आपने इतना एक्सलेंट लेक्चर दिया, और जो बहुत ज्यादा अच्छे श्रेष्ठ वैद्य निर्माण करने के लिए एक बहुत बड़ा मुकाम, ऐसे बहुत बड़ा एक पड़ाव लोगों के लिए साबित होगा। बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद डॉक्टर साहब।
थैंक यू वेरी मच मैम फॉर गिविंग मी दिस गोल्डन अपॉर्चुनिटी टू शेयर माय व्यूज ऑन दिस नेशनल प्लेटफॉर्म। और मैं ऐसे भगवान धन्वंतरी जी को ऐसे मेरी इच्छा करती हूँ कि ये प्लेटफॉर्म ऐसे ही चलता रहे, आजीवन चलता रहे। हाँ
बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद,
थैंक यू मैम, थैंक
और
यू।
आप जैसे स्पीकर मुझे मिलते रहे।
बिल्कुल मिलेंगे मैम, हम तो अभी छोटे हैं कि अभी हम ग्रो अप हो रहे हैं, वी आर जस्ट ग्रूमिंग, तो ऐसे बड़े बड़े भी आए तो हमें हमें भी वो एक प्रकार के हमें भी गाइडेंस मिलेगा। थैंक यू वेरी मच मैम, थैंक यू, थैंक यू मैम।
डॉक्टर दीपा मिश्रा मैडम, और कुछ नाम भूल जाऊं तो मुझे क्षमा प्रार्थी हूँ मैं। सभी का बहुत बहुत तहे दिल से धन्यवाद। सबसे लास्ट में मैं शांति मंत्र बोलूंगी, आप सभी म्यूट रखकर ही दोहराएंगे। ओम सर्वे भवन्तु सुखिनः, सर्वे सन्तु निरामया, सर्वे पत्राणि पश्यन्तु, मा कश्चित् दुःखभाग् भवेत्। ओम शांति शांति शांति। नमो नमः। विश्व मंगल की कामना के साथ अगले शुक्रवार को हम फिर सभी मिलेंगे और एक नए विषय के ऊपर नए व्याख्यानकर्ता के साथ हम फिर से एक ज्ञान यज्ञ में आहुति देकर अपने आप को इस श्रेष्ठ वैद्य बनने की परंपरा में आगे की ओर ले जाएंगे। बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद डॉक्टर साहब।
थैंक यू मैम, थैंक यू वेरी मच।